and we can show you a wiser way to build your wealth. So go to financialstrategiesinc.com and schedule a no-cost consultation.
Financial strategies, a wiser way to build your wealth.
Save now on heirloom quality furniture and mattresses at Ken Michaels Furniture's Labor Day sale.
Ah, nothing like a late summer dust up with an old foe.
On the ground, left side, tough play! Save! Ball game over!
The I-94 rivalry heats up as the Brewers travel south for a clash with the Cubs.
The Cubs get their hearts broken again.
Brewers-Cubs series is sponsored by Steinhoffel's Labor Day Sale. Our Brewers-Cubs coverage gets underway beginning at 12:45. We are your home of the Brewers. 620 WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 9:01, we're clocking in at 60 degrees, and we won't get much warmer today near Lake Michigan. A high of just 68 near the lake, 71 degrees inland under mostly sunny and breezy skies. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Adam Roberts. Hurricane Idalia is now the strongest hurricane to strike Florida's Big Bend region on the northwest coast since 1896. Touching down Wednesday morning, that's this morning, as a Category 3 storm with heavy rain, strong winds, and power outages affecting thousands. ABC's Victor Oquendo is in Tallahassee.
Tallahassee is covered in trees, and when Idalia makes her way through here, she is going to bring some of these trees down with near hurricane force winds topping 70 miles an hour. Power outages are going to be a real problem here. Statewide, 130,000 customers are already without power. That number is climbing here in Leon County, more than 13,000.
With hundreds of thousands possibly out of power, it is possible We Energy's crews from Wisconsin could be called down to help with recovery efforts. VP of Field Ops Dave Megna tells TMJ4 News they'll be ready, but how many crews they send down will be determined by our needs here first.
Typically, we send our contractors first, and then we look at if they need more resources, we'll look at internal crews. But it's all based on what's happening on our system, the weather. We don't want to deplete our resources so that we can't restore customers if something happens here.
Additionally, multiple flights from Milwaukee's Mitchell International to Florida have been canceled, with flights to Tampa and Orlando getting shut down. The Tampa International Airport closed this morning as Idalia reaches land. Milwaukee 11th District Alderman Mark Borkowski has said he will not seek re-election to the Common Council in 2024. Borkowski has served in public office on Milwaukee's South Side for 32 years and has held the Common Council seat since 2015's special election when his predecessor, Joe Dudzik, died in a motorcycling accident. As of today, Milwaukee County Supervisor Peter Burglis and Lee Whiting have both stated their intention to run for the seat in next year's general election. And a Brady Street Bar picking up the tab on Sundays this football season.
That's if and only if Aaron Rodgers' New York Jets lose. Jack's American Pub Director of Operations Ryan Cook tells Wisconsin's Afternoon News how the idea came about.
Well, we knew there was going to be a lot of interest to watch the Jets with so many former Packers players. And then just the degenerate gambling in our management group was like, yeah, let's just take the risk.
Cook says he's heard enthusiastic responses from Packers fans, less so from Jets fans.
Clearly some Jets fans who have never been to the bar, posting some fake reviews, just saying we're no good. Been pretty funny.
To qualify, you got to be at Jack's 15 minutes before game time and stay for the entire game. Wyatt Barmore Pooley, WTMJ News.
Time for news about your money. The WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Stocks were in the green at the opening bell and remain so now. The Dow Jones Industrial Average up 132 points to 34,985. The S&P 500 up 19 points to 4,517, and the NASDAQ Composite up 67 to 14,010. Get on track with investment and retirement planning. Visit AnnexWealth.com. Click the Get Started button today. Sports, traffic, and weather coming up next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 9:05.
Eric Smith here from Austin Plumbing. When you own a well pump, air spitting from the faucets, a decrease in fluctuating water pressure, along with silty, gritty, slimy changes in water quality, are all symptoms that your well pump isn't well. At Austin Plumbing, we're well-rounded plumbers. I say that because we're one of the few companies around who can capably diagnose and repair all the symptoms related to well pump and water system problems. You know when your car needs service, right? Maybe it makes unusual noises. It sputters, jerks, seems weak, or stops altogether. That goes for your well pump too. We have all the special equipment needed and the master know-how required to electronically pinpoint the exact cause of your well and water issues. And we'll give you a price up front before any work begins. If your well pump is telling you it's not well, let's nip small problems in the bud before you're out of water and in deep, expensive trouble. Told you we were well-rounded. Austin Plumbing, online at teamaustin.com.
Wisconsin is as hard-working of a place as you'll ever find. There's a sense of pride, community, and work ethic that's second to none. People here are tough, but even the toughest among us need help after a serious accident. At Gruber Law Offices, we won't stop fighting for you and your family. We've been here and will continue to be here for as long as you need us. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Welcome back to Ask Hassleless.
Know any good jokes?
Sure. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Sorry, Hassleless Mattress is employee-free, so nobody's here to answer the door.
No employees?
Try and buy with no pushy sales guy.
Are you joking?
Plus, through Monday, get a $200 MasterCard Rewards gift card with the purchase of a Beautyrest, Sealy Posturepedic, or Serta Perfect Sleeper.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Sorry, not home. I'm at Hassleless Mattress.
Find an employee-free showroom near you at Hassleless.
Time for a WTMJ sports update.
Tellez, line drive to left. Happ is there, makes the catch. And the Cubs shut out the Brewers tonight by a final score of 1-0.
Lane Grindle with the call on WTMJ. There will be no burgers after all as the Brewers fall 1-0 to the Cubs last night at Wrigley Field, ending their 9-game winning streak. The rubber match will be today on Chicago's North Side. Coverage gets underway at 12:45 right here on WTMJ. Taking a look at your roads now, your WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. Still a messy situation in the stadium interchange. Got that right now right shoulder being blocked due to a broken down vehicle. And we've also got the ramp from 35th Street heading on blocked as well as the two left lanes. I can talk. And that's blocking things all the way on 94 eastbound, also to about 76th Street. It's adding quite a few extra minutes to your drive. Right now, 94 west from the zoo to Highway 16 is at 13 minutes, and that ride from the zoo into downtown, 18 minutes right now. That is an extra 12. Also a bit slow on 43 southbound from Brown Deer into downtown, 19 minutes right now. That's an extra 8.
Traffic is sponsored by Smart Spaces. Adapt to the modern workplace. SmartSpacesWI.com.
How can Smart Spaces transform your business?
Creating technology, great culture, spaces that people really want to come to, attract talent, and keep that talent.
SmartSpacesWI.com.
Your WTMJ 5-day forecast. Clouds early, mostly sunny the rest of the day, breezy and cool. A high of 68 near the lake, 71 inland. Clear and cool overnight tonight, 56 at the lake. Could be in the mid to upper 40s at spots away from Lake Michigan. Sunny and pleasant for your Thursday, a high of 72. Mostly sunny Friday, a high of 88 degrees. Then Saturday and Sunday, we could be back into the 90s across the area. Partly to mostly sunny both days. Highs are at around 90 to 93 degrees. Currently in Madison, we're looking at 56 degrees. In Green Bay, it's 55. Waukesha checking in this morning at 57. And in downtown Milwaukee, partly cloudy skies and 60 degrees. I'm Adam Roberts. Siding Unlimited WTMJ News Time is 9:09.
Good morning, Wisconsin. It's WTMJ Now. News, opinions, Wisconsin. Everything you need to know in the Badger State and beyond. Come give us your thoughts on the old National Bank talk and text line at 855-616-1620. Old National Bank. Get old. Now here's your hosts, Sandy Bax and Steve Scafidi.
And good morning, everybody. Welcome to Hump Day Edition. It is Wednesday. It is the 30th day of August. Boy, this month has flown by. Sandy Bax alongside, as usual, 9 to noon before we hand it off to Mr. Wagner. Now, today is different, Sandy. Who's have a Brewers game this afternoon? Cubs Brewers. Now, they didn't keep the streak. I wore my Brewers shirt today.
Well done.
For the folks that are...
Well done.
Yes.
Looking good.
But they lost 1-0, so great pitching performances, not much hitting last night. But we'll see what happens today in an afternoon tilt. Brewers-Cubs, I think, our coverage begins about 12:45. So we'll have an extended edition of the WTMJ NAB program. So we start the show today I said this to Vince and Eric. One of the biggest questions I get, biggest whataboutisms, is whenever we talk about Donald Trump or politics, the question comes up on the text line, the old National Bank talking text line, 855-616-1620. What about Hunter Biden? He is the second son of the former vice president, now president. He's 53 years old. He was facing tax charges, failure to pay taxes, hundreds of thousands of dollars for money that he made. Gun charges, bought a gun. I was reading some stuff from the president's former vice president on his son, and he's had some really poignant statements. This is a kid, a son who's gone through a lot of tragedy in his life. He's lost his brother, yeah. Bo, who I met once at the White House many years ago. And then he was honest about it, and you can take this for what it's worth. He was a drug addict, cocaine, college. Not the only person that can probably talk about that, and we're going to talk about that in the 10 o'clock hour as well. So he's had an interesting life. But what I wanted to focus on, because so many people say, whenever you talk about the issues with the former president, what about Joe Biden's issues? And one of the biggest issues is, one, his relationship with his son, Hunter, and allegedly, a link between whatever dealings Hunter Biden has had with companies where he received money, made millions of dollars. I would argue he's probably not worth anywhere close to that, given on his work product and his lifestyle, cocaine, strippers, and all the rest. But he has certainly benefited from the relationship of having, admittedly, one of the most important political figures in the world as we know it, former vice president, now president. So that's the sort of the starting points. And we'll go through some of the specifics here. I mean, I don't want to bore you with all that stuff, but he's had relationships with other countries, other business holdings, where he has benefited from that relationship, serving on the boards of some of these organizations.
And controversial countries.
Yes.
Like Ukraine, yep. And China.
So that's kind of the starting point. But what I want from you is, I don't want internet conspiracy theories. And this is my baseline. Whatever there is here has to be proven in a court, just like whatever's out there against the former president must be proven in a court. Those are really important distinctions. We have court proceedings happening with the former president for indictments from Washington to Fulton County, Georgia, New York City, Department of Justice, with the FBI involved in some of these. And then we have this idea beyond the actual case of Hunter Biden, which was supposed to be a plea deal. Now it's not. Special counsel now appointed by the FBI. But that's all we have right now. So I want to hear from you on what you think this is. 855-616-1620. Is this a smoking gun? Is this an indictment? Is this a influence peddling by the President of the United States? But come with facts, not conjecture, not internet conspiracy theories. And I've said all along, old show, new show, if there's something here, then it should go through a legal process to determine if there's somebody did something criminally. And if that's the case, Hunter Biden should face the consequences. And oh yeah, the President of the United States, if he actually did what he's being accused of, which is using his influence to help his son or to help his son make money or to get sweetheart deals for companies or organizations around the world, then he should face those charges as well. But there's a process it has to go to. That's my take. 855-616-1620. Let's hear from you. What do you think? This is your moment for all the what about questions. What about Hunter Biden? Here's your moment to respond and to answer those questions. What do you think this is? Is it real or not real?
And I'll tell you one of the most interesting things about this whole situation that doesn't get talked about very much when we come back.
She's Sandy Max. I'm Steve. It is WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this.
Spaceship to Debbie. Come in, Debbie. Traffic is slowing down.
Yeah, Captain, there's an accident 2 miles ahead. Take the next exit for a quicker trip.
Making it through Milwaukee traffic isn't rocket science. Debbie Lozaga is looking out for you on the roads.
Traffic has woken up. We have an accident. We got a little bit of heavier traffic. We got pockets of heavy traffic. Oops, that's going to be tacking on a couple extra minutes there.
Follow her on Facebook and Twitter. Only on WTMJ.
Hey, this is WTMJ Steve's Committee for Educators Credit Union. I'm a member, joined last year. Love it. Love working with educators. When you open an Educators Credit Union checking account, you can say goodbye to surprise fees and hello to a whole lot of perks. Enjoy rewards, cash back, discounts, and their always popular card customization with their convenient digital services and nationwide network of over 60,000, yes, 60,000 fee-free ATMs. You can also access your account anytime, anywhere. Join Educators Credit Union today and take advantage of all the benefits that come with a checking account. Get started today at ecu.com. Federally insured, of course, by NCUA.
Lane's Farm and Fleet's Labor Day sale is going on now, featuring unbeatable deals on fall essentials for your home, work, and vehicles. Like 20% off Carhartt denim pants for the family, assorted KT designer welding helmets, $69.99. All Fram oil filters start at $5.49, $2 off Robic septic tank treatment. Plus, when your car's in the shop, get 10% off in-store purchases with $100 spent on tire and auto service. See store for details. Tires and batteries, trust and care. A Blaine's Farm and Fleet promise since 1955.
I've been living with a snoring problem nearly my entire life. In fact, I can remember my mother teasing me, saying that I'd snore so loudly that the walls of our house would cave in with each breath.
Fast forward only recently, when Jessica's snoring forced her husband out of their bed and into another room. It's a pretty common situation. We call it a sleep divorce, and that's not good. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula with Advent. After Jessica had a thorough breathing triangle evaluation, we found that her snoring problem required a simple solution. In-office balloon sinuplasty. It's a 20-minute procedure, and it works. You won't find it offered by Big Box Healthcare, but you will find it at Advent, where we offer every effective snoring and sleep apnea solution available. You can hear more of Jessica's story at AdventKnowsJessica.com and take your first step towards breathing well so you can live better.
Results may vary.
WTMJ now.
The facts are this against Hunter Biden. Gun charges, you can face up to 10 years in prison, a $250,000 fine. Tax charges, hundreds of thousands of dollars of tax. He has since paid it, but he didn't pay it when he was supposed to, like the rest of us. $100,000 fine, twice the gain or loss from the offense. So I guess my question is simple. Is there something here? Do you believe these charges? And is there a connection, do you feel, between Hunter Biden and his father, the current president of the United States? And I got some texts on. I'd love to hear from you on the phone as well, 855-616-1620. 414, there's a pattern with Joe Biden, president of the United States, starting with his sister earning big bucks running his campaigns back in the day. Interesting thing, Sandy, about all of this. Are we under the illusion that if you have money, if you come from wealth, if you have political power, that your kids aren't going to benefit from that? Because last time I checked, we not only have politicians who make a lot of money being in office, but their kids, their families, their profiles. A lot of people wonder why people go to Congress and as like regular folks, average folks, and come out as millionaires. Because they use that position and that power to get speaking fees, to make money doing other things. That's the reality of American politics, the reality of life. If you're a prominent person, people want to hear from you. People will pay for your time.
Because you have a unique experience.
Yes. Now, you mentioned something before the break that you wanted to talk about. You wanted to mention.
Of all the things, as I continue to do research, and because I do hear that as well, yes, but what about Hunter Biden? No one talks about he's a painter.
Yeah.
And that has also, or few people talk about it. So I'm sort of curious about that. And it turns out he is an artist, but that also ties into the controversy of who purchases his paintings and who commissions him and the ethics of that. But he's done art therapy as part of his coping with his drug addiction and I'm sure still grieving over his family loss. But so I just thought that he's a painter, you know, the artful side of me finds that an interesting aspect of him, yet unfortunately is part of the tangled Christmas lights that really is his life, whether it's his myriad romances, it's his business dealings, it's his drug addiction struggles. It's a complicated issue with him.
He's had a complicated life. Yeah. I mean, he had a child with a stripper. I mean, that whole story, I think the young child's name is Navy, first name, and the parents, Joe Biden and the first lady, are now recognizing that child. So that was a controversy. Right. Why are they ignoring that child? Now that's sort of changed. That narrative has changed.
Yeah, so for all the whatabouts, there's a lot of whatabouts, but it's more dramatic than incredibly criminal. But to all of our points, innocent until proven guilty, but there is now special counsel looking into him for over 5 years now.
Yeah.
So if there is something to be found, I'm confident it will be found and he will be charged with more if so.
And the thing for me is, if we are going to actually trust our justice system, which I think we have to do, otherwise we have a society that's just chaotic and unruled or unruly, I think we have to trust the process. And in the case of the individual that's in charge of the special counsel, this is somebody that was appointed by Trump. I mean, this is not a Joe Biden thing. I mean, you don't have to like who they picked, but it's a long investigation, as Sandy said, 5 years. Jim from Oconomowoc, it's the same as the Gableman investigation. I don't think so, Jim, but I'll continue reading your text. An idea looking for evidence. And the same as the Ukraine folly. Merely announcing an investigation is enough to smear Joe Biden. Well, that's how politics works. You can say almost anything. It's free speech. Crazy political conversation. One of the things I've learned from doing a show is politicians can lie. It's protected free speech. And they take advantage of that every day. They can lie about whatever they want to. Brad says,
and believe whatever they want to.
Yes,
it would seem.
Yes, Brad says, I believe there's smoke. There's probably a fire. As you said, I also believe we need to follow a legal process. My concern is that given our FBI and DOJ, we will not see an unbiased and thorough process. I've heard this complaint a lot. So who are you going? If you don't trust the institutions of our government, who are you going to trust? A kangaroo court? A bunch of guys slapping on tech vests they bought on the internet who are going to assemble a group and they're going to weigh the evidence and make a decision? Who are you going to trust if it's not our institutions and our justice system? That's what we have, folks. I'm not jumping in, as some people want to, with kangaroo courts and citizen justice. That's not how it works. From the 414, Steve, last time I checked, the name Hunter Biden does not have POTUS following it. GOP themselves admitted they have no evidence, not even circumstantial, on Joe Biden regarding Hunter Biden. At this moment, no evidence has been presented. Yes. Now, Congress, Republicans in Congress, are going to look into all of this because they have the right to. That's part of their mission statement of being elected officials in Congress. They can look at, they can investigate these things. When the questions are raised, they can spend time on committees, have hearings, bring in witnesses to look at all this stuff. But I need to see the evidence. If you're going to make this grand leap that says the President of the United States, or in his former role as the Vice President of the United States, basically meddled with influence peddling, we know that some anecdotal evidence exists that he was on a phone conversation with his son and some of these foreign individuals. Mm-hmm. Did he ever offer anything? Is there any email evidence? Is there anything written down? Is there an audio recording? Those are real pieces of evidence. Other than the internet conspiracy theories, I just don't know what else you can do. It's kind of like the same thing with the former president. He has 4 indictments. The case still has to be proved. You have to have evidence. So we'll find out if state of New York, Fulton County, Georgia, Department of Justice, Washington, D.C., if they have the evidence, they'll have to present in court. We'll find out. And I always have to tell people this, as much as I'm not a fan of the former president, he is innocent until proven guilty. And when I see the evidence that suggests he's innocent, we'll talk about it. Lots of conversation on the text line. Love to have you on the phone. We'll take a quick break here. Still time to get in. We're going to be joined by Tori Lowe talking about the controversy in Milwaukee with City of Milwaukee Housing Authority. Big story that he's all over on the one of our partner stations, sister stations, 101.7 The Truth, Tori Lowe. He'll join us about 9:30 or so. So jump on in the conversation, 855-616-1620. Sandy Mac, Steve Scafidi, WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this.
When you need news the most.
Police in South Milwaukee continuing to investigate.
In Washington, D.C., history happening on the House floor.
We are here for you.
Looks like we've got a broken down vehicle.
A power outage in West Allis has affected class at several schools.
We are Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio WTMJ.
Heard at work? If you or someone you know has been injured on the job, they may be eligible for workers' compensation benefits, including lost wages, coverage of medical bills, job retraining, and even a lump sum cash settlement. I'm attorney Alex Eichhorn, partner and workers' compensation attorney at Tabak Law. The workers' compensation system can be complicated and frustrating to navigate. At Tabak Law, we have helped hundreds of injured workers. Contact Tabak Law to set up an absolutely risk-free consultation at TabakAttorneys.com. Contact Tabak for the payback, TabakAttorneys.com.
Since 1946, Ansay & Associates has provided insurance to help secure families throughout Wisconsin. As a family-owned, independent agency, customer satisfaction is our first priority. Our experienced and local agents are here to assess your individual needs and ensure your family is protected. As one of Wisconsin's top 10 insurance agencies, Ansay & Associates is here to provide all of your insurance needs, from home and auto to life insurance and specialty coverage. Our local agents will ensure your family is prepared for the unexpected. Ansay & Associates is more than insurance. We're your partner in risk management. Visit ansay.com today and get a free consultation with one of our experienced local agents, or come see us in person at any of our local offices. Ansay & Associates, securing and protecting your American dream. Learn more at ansay.com. That's ansay.com.
My part-time service in the Army National Guard makes it possible for me to be more for the community I call home. My training helps me at work when I lead by example. My service in the Army National Guard allows me to keep my community and those I care about safe from threats. Learn more about how you, too, can live and serve part-time close to home by visiting NationalGuard.com.
Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
Hunter Biden controversy. No, somebody just sent me a text. DOJ and FBI corrupt at the top. Nobody you can trust until they're gone. So I responded. So what's the alternative? Kangaroo courts? We're just going to assemble and citizen justice, or they're going to go, you know, string up somebody because they don't like or they think that somebody broke the law? What's the alternative? We have to trust our institutions. We have to figure out how we can get back to that. That's the bigger question.
Agreed.
Now, if you're watching on the stream, you just got a little content that the folks on the radio didn't get.
We were talking about Hunter Biden is a painter. He started with art therapy and has had art gallery showings and is represented by a particular art gallery. And our producer, Charlie, found a painting and shared it. It looks like kind of the writings of the Constitution on this sky blue background with hands reaching towards it. But I asked Charlie, what's the title of the painting? Untitled Number Two.
Yeah.
Which is a funny title for a painting.
So you're a subject matter expert on the arts community, because you cover that for a long time. You've covered it for a long time.
I have
time.
My
and
moments.
Still do. I mean, I'm not going to judge. I guess art is subjective, and I'm not going to judge whether I think this is great art or not, but somebody's buying these things. Now, being famous sort of gives you a window or an opportunity to sell paintings, right? Howard Stern sells paintings. I've seen some of them. I don't think they're great art, but he's Howard Stern. You could look at famous Andy Warhol. Not everything he did was amazing. Some of it was.
Frank Sinatra and Tony Bennett were painters.
Yeah, and I've seen some of Tony Bennett's works, too, and actually kind of like them. I wouldn't mind having one, but can't afford it. But there is a question there whether people are buying these things because they're great art or just because it's a way to finance Hunter Biden.
Right, and that's where these paintings have also come under scrutiny in all the other scrutiny between laptops and illegal gun purchases, et cetera, et cetera. Even his artwork has come under scrutiny because is it ethical to sell? Are those considered donations? Is he being commissioned? So none of it is just straightforward when it comes to the Bidens in this situation.
Yeah, 262, all kinds of evidence. Multiple people on the inside have testified the Biden corruption. Get rid of people at the top. No other alternative. The only way you get rid of people at the top is you vote them out.
That is very true.
We've seen how impeachment doesn't work. I mean, you have your thoughts about Donald Trump in any way that you want to, and certainly I understand he's still popular, but we have to understand there's a process. If we're throwing out the process, whatever that means to you in your world, whether you don't trust the Department of Justice, FBI, CIA, the administration, either side, Trump administration, certainly the Biden administration, what's your alternative here? Real life alternative. Evidence must be presented in courts. The thing that drives me nuts, and I think Kathy made the point early. I'm going to read it right now. It's ironic to me that the same people who point the finger at Hunter Biden look the other way at all the things that Donald Trump has been accused of. That is sort of interesting. So you want the process for Hunter Biden, but you are unhappy with the process for Donald Trump. That seems inconsistent to me.
I think the right way to look at it, my opinion, if we're going to have a process, a legal process, we know what it is. We have courts, various levels of courts. They can move up, appeals courts, right? Federal courts, U.S. Supreme Court. The process has to follow along through those steps. If there's a crime committed, there's an appeal process. But if you're found guilty and all appeals are exhausted, you're guilty. That's America. Whether you're former President Donald Trump or Hunter Biden, or if there is a connection between Hunter Biden and his dad, father, president, then those things should go forward.
And don't mess with Georgia. You know, the sayings usually don't mess with Texas.
Yeah.
And, you know, Georgia has been the hub of activity for the latest indictment for former President Trump and 18 other people. Well, now, as of yesterday, according to Newsweek magazine, there is a legal advocacy group based in Atlanta called the Southeastern Legal Foundation, and they are trying to gain custody from the National Archives and Records Administration, or to get a look at 5,400 emails as a further investigation into influencer peddling, mm-hmm. or influence peddling.
Yeah.
Influencers is social media, but influence peddling, because now there may be emails between President Biden under pseudonyms to his son. And what would those contain? So believe me, the investigations do continue on both sides.
And they should, rightly so. Whether you're a fan of former president or the current president, those investigations have every right to proceed. You don't have to like them. You can cheerlead for your political side or your president, former or current. That has nothing to do with the legal process. And when the former president likes to complain about the fact that the election was rigged, there was a legal process, 65 cases, I believe. And he had one slight win, and everyone else basically got thrown out because there was nothing there, nothing to see. And he lost every one of them. That's the legal process. And now this next phase is all the indictments related to his conduct post-election.
I feel like transparency is a really big deal that we as voters need to demand more of and follow up on. For example, like former President Trump never released tax documents.
Yeah, even though
people said that was very important. But he wound up getting elected into power anyway without releasing that. Which again, you talk about what would all the rest of us have to be required to do. I'd have to do that mm-hmm. if I wanted to get elected. All of these things that we're dealing with, there's a lack of transparency and there's a suspicion. So let's demand more of that, whether it is cameras in courts. I mean, it's all to be discussed. There is no one blanket answer. But I think when we also have our conversation with Tory Lowe here in a few minutes about what's happening here in Milwaukee with the housing issues, again, it's a lack of transparency, which also doesn't build trust. So let's demand more from our people in charge.
I'll read one more text before the break. Reason people aren't satisfied with the answer, no matter what it is, that whoever's in power will be biased against the other side. There will never be the true justice, and I don't know how you fix that. So something I've been talking about for years is when we went down this road of cheerleading about politics or cheerleading for politics, demonizing the other side, abandoning compromise, consensus in favor of strictly partisan ideas and policy, this is the byproduct. Institutional trust out the window. People don't even trust doctors anymore, for Pete's sake. And they get their news and information not from a trusted source. And again, no one's perfect. Even Dr. Fauci and CDC experts and local medical professionals, they all made mistakes. They do every day. Again, there's a process for that. There's a review process. But once you have no trust in any of that, you don't really have a country that has a solid foundation. It's weakened by that. And to the texter's point, we have to get back to that somehow. We have to figure it out. My thoughts all along have been, it starts with baby steps, little compromises. We saw it a little bit in Wisconsin with some of the shared revenue stuff, little pieces. We may see it on the tax piece, and we're going to talk about that on tomorrow's show. Some proposals about taxation in Wisconsin. If they're willing, the sides are willing to work together, and if the talking heads start understanding that, if the news media starts to get the idea that Americans are concerned about the state of their country, then maybe we'll get some progress here. We're not going to settle the Hunter Biden story, but I wanted to give everybody a chance to weigh in. There's a lot of text on us. Maybe we'll get back to it at some point. But there's always going to be these controversies because that's what the world we have created is when it comes to politics. Hatred of the other side, screaming at the top of your lungs because they're doing this and they're doing that. You're not getting what you want. That's the reality that we've created. You can blame it on Joe Biden, Donald Trump, whoever you want. Point the finger at yourself. That's the problem. Quick break.
And I would say even more distrust from the 414 on the old National Bank talking text line, 855-616-1620. Texted, can't vote them out if they steal the election. So again, you're not listening. Bless you. But
that's
thank you
more
for listening,
than a thousand days ago.
Yeah, but
come on. We're smarter than that. Be smarter than that. Listen better. Be smarter. Quick break.
More of WTMJ now after this.
Russ bought his first home in Wisconsin with a mortgage from Acunet when today's college freshmen were still in diapers. A few Friday mornings ago, Russ emailed saying he and his wife were ready to buy their forever home. And by 4 o'clock, we were all on a conference call with a real estate agent talking about what it would take to write a winning offer in today's inventory-starved market. And then it happened. They met their dream home face-to-face Saturday afternoon and wrote an offer $15,000 over asking, accompanied by an Acunet property-specific pre-approval letter that guaranteed they could make good on that offer without selling their existing home first and without requiring an appraisal. That's right, no appraisal required, which both the listing agent and seller loved. I can't promise your very first offer will be accepted like Russ and Julie's, but I will promise Acunet can help you and your agent craft the most attractive offer possible. Hey, don't settle for a flimsy, unimaginative bank pre-approval. Get started with your rock-solid, guaranteed pre-approval by clicking on the blue button today at accunet.com.
After a serious crash with a semi-truck, everything can change instantly. Your future, your family's future, your quality of life. That's why knowledge and results matter in big truck cases. And not all law firms have the know-how or the resources to handle these complicated cases. At Grunberg Law Offices, we have the experience it takes to make sure you're protected. And there's never a fee until we win your case. Grunberg Law Offices. One call, that's all.
Hey, WTMJ's John Merck here. When it comes to memory care and assisted living, you want a team that knows compassion and empathy. That's Azura Memory Care and Assisted Living. I know, my grandma was in assisted living. I have an aunt, one of my favorite aunts, right now in memory care. At Azura, they specialize in caring for those with early to late stage Alzheimer's or other related dementia symptoms. They provide additional daily living assistance for those with cognitive decline. 14 locations in Wisconsin, AzuraLiving.com, Wisconsin-based, family-owned. The teams I trust are at Azura, AzuraLiving.com.
It's WTMJ Now.
I always love when this guy comes in. He is one of the guys and gals at 101.7 The Truth, one of our partner stations for GKB. Tory Lowe, The Tory Lowe Show, 1-4 on 101.7 The Truth. Good morning, sir.
Hey, how you doing, Scafidi?
Good. Sandy Max is here as well.
How you doing, Sandy Max?
I am very well. Glad to see you.
Man, you were telling me about the story about the bidding on an auction.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And Sandy was firing you
Sandy
up.
Sandy fired me up to almost getting a bidding war at the one of the recent auctions.
The Penfield Children's Center gala on Saturday.
Yeah, it was the gala. And
Tori and I might have been making a very substantial donation.
Yeah, how'd that work out?
No, we was going to have to split it.
Oh, too big.
If we'd have landed it, we'd have had to split it.
I would have taken full ownership because I was encouraging you because there's a thrill to bidding first on some of these massive, impressive live auction items that you see.
Oh, she's the expert.
Oh, no.
I would bet Sandy's been at more events than probably anybody in this building.
Of course.
But it was a good time. We had a thrill. We had a laugh.
Oh, it was amazing time.
All right, so you're here for a serious conversation. We've heard this on our airwaves as well. Questions, challenges to the Housing Authority of the City of Milwaukee. The initials are HACM, I believe, is how they the acronym, right? HACM.
Right.
Yeah. So complaints about lost records, eviction notices sent to people who don't deserve them, don't warrant those, not things not getting repaired, all these things related to housing, which, what's the number? It's a big number in the city of Milwaukee.
I think the city of Milwaukee have 4,000 units.
Yeah, 4,000 units.
Right.
So people got together, I believe it was Monday nights.
Right.
One of the local churches, and said, what's going on here? Is the city of Milwaukee...
They need answers.
Yeah, is the city of Milwaukee addressing this?
Well, you know, they're... You know, I think that right now, salute to Safe and Sound. They're trying to get this all together. This is an organization in the city of Milwaukee, so they're tackling this issue. But I've had issues in the past with people who live in city-owned buildings complaining about infestation, things like that. And these are our elders. you know, of all races living in these facilities, and many times it's not going properly addressed.
Well, safety issues?
Safety issues, a lot of things that are happening right now. So they're tired. They are tired of what's going on, and they're coming together to say, hey, we want to audit. You know, they want to audit on the housing authority in the city of Milwaukee.
The comments I've seen the city make, city representatives make, is that this is a lot of pandemic-related issues.
Yeah, but...
Do you buy that?
No, I don't. You know, in a pandemic, you know, people blame things on a pandemic because it sounds good, you know. But sometimes it comes down to mismanagement and people not, you know, doing things properly. So that's why they're requesting an audit so we can see what's going on with the paperwork.
That's what we were just talking about, is transparency.
Right.
And I think it's legitimate to ask for oversight on finances are being, and if it is mismanagement, knowing the truth about something helps us deal with it.
Right. Because everybody's going to try to make an excuse that sounds good. A lot of people pay PR, you know, to handle these, you know, public ideas where the people rise up. But the true way to really handle these things is check the paperwork. Who's doing what? And what's happening, and this is where it's come to for a lot of these residents.
Do you believe that it's a manpower issue, womanpower issue of, you know, the workforce that's involved in these 4,000 plus units, or is it something else, something greater?
Well, it's a lot of areas in the city, and particularly, you know, on the north side, where mismanagement comes up, where, you know, people, you know, are not managing the tax dollars or, you know, the city ideas correctly. And this is not the only situation where people have challenged, hey, what's really going on here? But I think that when it comes to housing, I mean, when you get in your early, in your late years, you want to relax. You don't want to have to be...
You don't want an eviction notice shoved under your door with a major payment.
You don't want to be charged a late fee and you paid it on time, you know? It's, and then they raise the rent. You know, and many times a lot of people have budgeted out, you know, their bills. And then next thing you know, these things pop up and it creates a lot of confusion, a lot of stress for a lot of elderly.
And raising the rent is not just as simple as, oh, well, then I'll move, because there's a cost to that and a super inconvenience to that. And finding a new space within your budget when you have committed to this. And the other disappointing thing to me is, we were talking about lack of transparency. When you've got 200 people who are showing up going, this is a real issue. This is our everyday lives.
Right.
And we want to talk, hash this out, get some answers. And you've got the regional administrator who said she was going to attend and then found out it was actually going to be Q&A, wasn't just a prepared statement, and didn't show up.
Some people are ducking the real questions, you know, and
that's not going to help anything. That's not going to progress. And it's only going to make people angrier.
I had a guy call into my show yesterday, and he's in a building where he says that there are people, many times younger people, in some of these facilities as well with the elderly, but they have severe mental health ideas and they're not taking their medication. And things are going on and people are just going crazy. And the people that are our elders that are living in these facilities, they're told, hey, if you don't like it, get out.
You're an action guy.
Right.
I'm an action guy. What's going to fix this, or at least get us moving in the right direction?
Well, let's see what's going on with the paperwork. I think they're on the right track with the audit, you know, especially when it comes to the city ideas, taxpayers are spending money on this. I think once we can get the paper trail in front of us, because as long as we don't see what's going on with the paper trail, they can say whatever, COVID, you know, X, Y, and Z.
They were transitioning to a different software system, which we know that can be a headache and a heartache. And if that's really what it is, then...
Then it'll show on the paperwork.
Yeah, and then great, then get the IT help. Let's get this shaped up and tell me what time frame. It's managing expectations.
Right.
And we do this in our personal lives and our professional lives. Just shoot straight and tell me what to expect.
And I'm getting older. Pretty soon I'll be in one of these facilities.
You're not that old.
Wait a minute. I want to get this stuff straightened out right now.
But what if your mom was in there? You know, you want your family and people you care about.
You
got to
get this stuff straightened out now.
There's nothing more sacred than your home.
Right.
Whatever that is, apartment, condo, trailer, whatever it is.
That's your safe space.
Yes. And if you're talking about disadvantaged people, people who have special needs, elderly, why wouldn't we want to make sure that this is buttoned up?
Right.
And I'm not accepting city of Milwaukee. I'm not accepting paperwork problems. Because according to the reports, both from a TV source and a newspaper source, people paid their bills.
Right.
They had receipts.
Those bills were paid. Yeah.
And they still shoved an eviction notice under their door. That's never acceptable.
And they felt like they had to get out. Horrible. After they paid their rent on time.
All right, we're talking to Tory Lowe, 101.7 The Truth, on the controversy in Milwaukee with the housing authority affecting 4,000 potentially residents, units rather, more thousands more residents. I want to ask you a question I think one of the texters alluded to. Is this a disproportionate impact on people of color in the city of Milwaukee? Hold off on your answer. We'll get to that after this on WTMJ Now.
Sandy and Steve will be back after this.
I love the Fox and Hounds restaurant. WTMJ's John Mercier here. The historic restaurant was recently voted one of the top supper clubs in the area. That's what I'm talking about. It first opened in 1933 and has been serving fabulous dinners for almost 90 years in their rustic timber structure. And when you buy one dinner, your second dinner is free 7 days a week. Every Wednesday, when you buy one world-class prime rib dinner, your second prime rib dinner is free. Order anything on the menu. Your second dinner is free. Made from scratch desserts, buy one, get one free. Ice cream drinks, buy one, get one free. The Fox and Hounds is family-owned and one of the most unique and affordable supper clubs in Wisconsin. Your second dinner is always free. Just off Highway 167, 2 miles east of Holy Hill, it is spectacular. The flowers are out. The trees are blooming. The summer drive is a must-see. Enjoy a free prime rib dinner tonight at the award-winning Fox & Hounds Restaurant. Reserve at foxandhoundsrestaurant.com. It will lift your spirits. It's the famous Fox & Hounds.
Eric Smith here from Austin Plumbing. When you own a well pump, air spitting from the faucets, a decrease in fluctuating water pressure, along with silty, gritty, slimy changes in water quality, are all symptoms that your well pump isn't well. At Austin Plumbing, we're well-rounded plumbers. I say that because we're one of the few companies around who can capably diagnose and repair all the symptoms related to well pump and water system problems. You know when your car needs service, right? Maybe it makes unusual noises. It sputters, jerks, seems weak, or stops altogether. That goes for your well pump too. We have all the special equipment needed and the master know-how required to electronically pinpoint the exact cause of your well and water issues. And we'll give you a price up front before any work begins. If your well pump is telling you it's not well, let's nip small problems in the bud before you're out of water and in deep, expensive trouble. Told you we were well-rounded. Austin Plumbing. Online at teamaustin.com.
Save now on heirloom quality furniture and mattresses at Ken Michaels Furniture's Labor Day sale.
It's not a gimmick. It's simply comprehensive, fee-only financial planning to get all your arrows pointed in the right direction. And although rate of return is important, there are many factors that are equally, if not more important. There's a strong belief among financial experts that tax planning is more important than rate of return. And at Financial Strategies, we strongly believe that is what sets us apart. As a result of our strategies, our clients have saved significantly on their taxes. They were prepared to pay the taxes and elated when we shared how they could avoid them. We want to grow your investment and protect it. And we've proven to be very good at doing just that. I'm Jim Cantrell with Financial Strategies, Inc., and we can show you a wiser way to build your wealth. So go to financialstrategiesinc.com and schedule a no-cost consultation.
Financial Strategies, a wiser way to build your wealth.
WTMJ Now.
Tory Lowe, 101.7 The Truth, our guest in studio for a few more minutes. We're talking about the controversy, housing authority of the city of Milwaukee, and some of the conditions, some of the reports are, and you've been in some of these facilities, they're just ridiculous.
Right.
And these are folks who need help.
Right.
It defines the eligibility, right? They need help financially, but they need help in other ways too. A lot of them are special needs. Elderly have special needs that they need to have those needs met. I asked before the break, does this disproportionately impact people of color, or is it just everybody?
It's everybody. A lot of different races live in these facilities across the board. You know, city situations that give resources, a lot of people take advantage of these resources, and the neglect makes me sick to my stomach.
As somebody who works, and you call yourself a community advocate.
Right.
As somebody who works in this, is this there's a trend to be more cases like this or less, do you think? Is this getting worse?
Well, it's getting worse. And not only in Milwaukee, but all across the country. I read an article in USA Today that said that they're trying to put a cap on landlords just raising the rent, you know, because so many people are facing evictions. So when it comes to housing, there's a lot of different ideas going on where people are not able to afford housing, which is shocking to me because, you know, this is America.
We have at least one local organization, Common Ground, who's pushing for an audit. Is there a way to expedite that? Are there other organizations who are going to put pressure? Is there something a citizen can do?
Well, they're going to have a rally at City Hall to talk to the Common Council. So when that happens, then that is a time to get our leadership involved to say, hey, look, we demand these things to take place. And like I said, this is the way to approach it, because if you don't approach it this way, you don't get the answers. And right now they're doing the right steps. Salute to Common Ground for actually taking the initiative to organize what's going on with the audit on the Housing Authority.
And salute to you as well, because I know you don't take no. You don't take no for an answer. You want to get to the bottom of this and help these people.
I'll get a lawyer. I mean, like I said, you know, if you really want to know what's going on, you get an attorney. You know, so many of my cases, they end up in court because sometimes people will protect the brand over the people, and so when that happens, when they put that defense up, you got to file some type of suit to get the answers.
And we will reach out to the Housing Authority of the City of Milwaukee for their comments. They have a statement out. I'm not going to read it for you, but if you want to look it up, it's in the JS piece that we were referring to, what they said about this. And they are attributing a lot of this to paperwork and some a little bit to the pandemic as well. I don't accept it. I don't think you do as well. Stay on it. We'll continue to keep this conversation going.
All right. Thank you, Sandy. Thank you, Scafidi. Hey, I'll keep you updated.
All right, Tory Lowe, 1-4 on 101.7 The Truth. Always great to hang out. And now I get to be on your show again.
Hey, I love it. I love it when you come on my show.
All right, I'm looking forward to that.
Hey,
quick break on WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this. We heard that they have been pretty hot lately. It'd be a shame if they burned out.
Swung on, hit in the air, deep into center field, back on it goes Taylor, back onto the track, at the wall, it is gone! William Contreras!
The Brewers are at Wrigley for a three-game series against the Cubs. Our Brewers Radio Network game day coverage starts today at 12:45. We are the home of the Brewers, 620 WTMJ. This series is sponsored by Steinhoffel's Labor Day Sale.
What's that sound?
That's the sweet sound of you, small business owner, not having to worry about cybersecurity.
Sounds nice.
U.S. Cellular is offering cybersecurity protection with unlimited data for $29.99 per line.
Does that include protection from phishing?
Of course. Unless you mean like the... kind. Get cybersecurity protection with unlimited data for $29.99. U.S. Cellular. Built for business. Built for us. Terms apply. Visit uscellular.com for details.
Demi Lozaga here. I've been wanting to shade in my backyard for years, and now that dream is coming true thanks to my friends at Comfort Awnings, located in Burlington. It's a local family-owned company that provides expert installation servicing southeast Wisconsin and northern Illinois. They came out to my house and walked me through the whole process, from different colors and fabrics, custom fit to my home's exterior and backyard. Right now, you can receive $200 off awnings and screens until the end of August. Call 414-AWNINGS for a free estimate or visit comfortawnings.com.
Annex Wealth Management, investment, retirement, tax, and estate planning from a fee-only fiduciary. Forgive commission sales pitches and financial products you don't need. Know the difference. Annex provides elite, comprehensive financial planning customized to who you are and what you need. AnnexWealth.com.
Alleviate your pain, rejuvenate your life.
We want to decrease your pain as fast as possible. When we inject our powerful, FDA-approved anti-inflammatory and cushioning medicine, precisely guided to the root of your pain, in most cases, relief in hips, shoulders, elbows, and knees is a reality. For those who go through our entire process, we can very much control and reduce your pain while increasing your quality of life. Thousands of Juvenex patients maintain their pain relief with semi-annual to annual treatments, proven to reduce inflammation, to make pain a lot more bearable. Some providers may charge up to $8,000 for similar treatments. At Rejuvenex, because we're in-network with most major insurance plans, including Medicare and Medicaid, your out-of-pocket expense could be as low as $400, or less, or nothing at all. I'm Richard Salinas, registered nurse with Rejuvenex Arthritis Pain Clinics, where you can find pain relief, really.
Rejuvenex.
Juvenex.com to request your appointment.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station. It's WTMJ Now.
Busy first hour. We'll continue. We've got some invited guests coming in. The National Overdose, International Overdose Day tomorrow.
A subject that has touched so many people.
Yeah. I mean, we're just talking about Hunter Biden, his cocaine abuse and other drugs. And this impacts, I don't care what your level in society is, from the lowest to the highest, mm-hmm. richest, rich, poor, all people of all color. It is an amazing scourge on our country. And something we have to pay attention to, fentanyl and some of the other dangerous drugs, you know, circulating in our population. People that aren't even really drug users, but have one time and, you know, the rest of their life, however short that may be, is changed forever. Their family's lives changed forever. And I've told stories on the air about some people that I know anonymously about some of the things they've gone through. Serious stuff.
And we'll be able to share with you some resources that are available here in Wisconsin, because a lot of people may be going through it. And it's just good to be armed and prepared. So we're here to help on International Overdose Awareness Day.
And we'll do some fun stuff later on. My friends from the Oak Creek Lions Club, they got a big Labor Day festival coming up this weekend. So they'll join us in studio, as they do every year. They're great partners of us here.
I won a brick of cheese there a couple of years ago.
I've won salamis, cheese, almost too much cheese. Yeah, the wheel, what is the wheel of cheese, wheel of beef, or whatever they call it, meat raffles.
And great music, yeah.
Yeah, and a great
it's a fun annual event.
If you like local music, this is the place to go, and this is why they have mega crowds every year. And it looks like they're going to get, again, greeted with some great weather.
Yeah.
It's going to be warm and sunny and perfect festival weather. I just wanted to quickly, before the top of the hour, I always go into the Hunter Biden, Joe Biden, Donald Trump segments, understanding that it's going to make some people mad. And I got a bunch of texts, some on my personal line, about, well, you're leaning left, that you're not giving, you know, proper due to the Hunter Biden story. All I'm saying, folks, take folks out of it. All I'm saying is, just like the Donald Trump story, things have to be proven in a court of law. I could care less about the politics of it. If you've committed a crime and you're convicted, you're going to do the time. Don't care if it's Joe Biden, Hunter Biden, Donald Trump, Mark Meadows, pick somebody. Don't care about the politics. If you've gleaned anything from listening to me and now our new show, I don't care about that. I want the truth. And if it's ugly or it doesn't match your politics, I don't care. We do not read political talking points. There's plenty of places you can find that. This is not one of those places. Sorry. Not sorry.
And a lot of this news is fascinating and entertaining, but it is always good to remember that in this country, innocent until proven guilty.
Absolutely. And if there's something there, we will talk about it, because we're a news station and, patting ourselves on the back. We do it better than anybody else in this state. So you have that. Speaking of news, it's next on WTMJ.
More of WTMJ Now after this.
HNTB, much like downtown Milwaukee, is on an accelerated growth track. Hi, I'm Ashley Booth, the Wisconsin office leader and a vice president of HNTB. The opportunities in downtown Milwaukee are endless, and it continues to be a tremendous location for retaining and attracting talent. I love working downtown, and so do all of our employees. Experience it for yourself. Go to MilwaukeeDowntown.com.
I already have a will. Won't that keep me out of probate? Hi, I'm Kim Steinbrenner with Steinbrenner Financial Group and your Dave Ramsey SmartVestor Pro. Tune in to the Dave Ramsey program weeknights at 9 o'clock or visit SteinbrennerGroup.com to learn more.
Next time you're due for service, visit Richlands.com to schedule an appointment at any of our 5 conveniently located facilities.
All AAA approved and all staffed by ASC certified technicians ready to serve you. Richlands!
The place you want to go, Lynch McGuanago.
Nobody sells for less than Lynch.
Ah, nothing like a late summer dust up with an old foe.
On the ground, left side to play. Safe! Ball game over!
The I-94 rivalry heats up as the Brewers travel south for a clash with the Cubs.
The Cubs get their hearts broken again.
Brewers Cubs Series is sponsored by Steinhoffel's Labor Day Sale. Our Brewers Cubs coverage gets underway beginning at 12:45. We are your home of the Brewers. 620 WTMJ, Milwaukee.
Going up to a high in the mid-70s today. I'm Eric Bilstead from the WTMJ Breaking News Center. Idalia is now on land. It is hitting Florida. It's a now Category 1 hurricane as it churns into Georgia, first making landfall on the Big Bend section of Florida. It's bringing major wind, rain, coastal flooding to the communities up and down the west coast of Florida there. Forecasters also say there's areas along Idalia's path that are likely to see some life-threatening storm surges as well. ABC's Trevor Holt is watching what happens in the air.
We're heading into a pretty busy travel weekend for the holiday this weekend. TSA says they're going to be screening more than 14 million passengers through the long Labor Day weekend. That's more than a 10% increase from this time last year. In fact, they say the stretch from Memorial Day up through this coming weekend is the single busiest summer stretch of travel we have ever seen. So on top of dealing with the hurricane for the next day or so and beyond with the travel, could be quite chaotic if you're going to an airport.
As far as on the ground, ABC's Maria Viriel.
Earlier this morning, we had a break from the rain, but really what we've seen overnight since about midnight here in Gainesville is a steady amount of heavy rain. And it comes, you know, with the bands coming. Basically, I'm calling this kind of a hip check for Idalia as she makes landfall or as the storm makes landfall.
Again, Hurricane Idalia now a Category 1 storm as it moves to the north into Georgia. Tens of thousands out of power at the moment. The wildfire smoke and the air quality alerts may soon return to northern Wisconsin.
Chief Health Policy Advisor for Milwaukee County, Dr. Ben Weston, says everyone should avoid the outdoors when particles known as PM2.5 are at the highest levels.
And these can enter deep into your lungs and cause inflammation and damage, and that's what makes folks sick.
Dr. Weston adds that wildfire smoke and conditions like asthma are an especially dangerous combination.
When wildfire smoke levels are high and those particulate matters are high, there were 17% higher than expected emergency department visits for asthma.
Jessica Gatso, WTMJ News.
Some radio news in Milwaukee, new local voices, and a brand new show coming to our sister station 94.5 ESPN Milwaukee later this month, or into September, I should say. Director of content Brian D tells WTMJ.
From 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. is going to have Ben Brust, former Badger. People love him, and he's turned into an awesome radio host. Former NFLer Brad Nortman, who's a local guy, went to Brookfield Central, punted for the Badgers. He's joining the family alongside Kyle Wallace. Amazing guy. He's been our director of content for 101.7 The Truth.
Again, new shows coming to ESPN Milwaukee 94.5. Time now for news about your money and the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update. Right now, the Dow is up 14 to 34,867. The NASDAQ is up 45 to 13,989. And the S&P is up 10 to 4507. Get on track with investment and retirement planning. Visit nxwealth.com and click the Get Started button today. Sports, traffic, and weather next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 10:04.
I'm not exaggerating when I say this. QC Kinetics can change your life. You can live again without that chronic joint pain and without drugs or surgery. Hey, it's Greg Mancic. QC Kinetics is advanced regenerative medicine. They take your body's own concentrated healing properties and put them right into your joint to restore and repair that damaged tissue that's causing all of that horrible pain. Patient satisfaction reports are astonishing. Finally, a real alternative to the old ways of dealing with pain. And unlike surgery, there is no downtime with QC treatments. If you have constant pain in your knees, hips, shoulder, or back, you have to give a call and get a free consultation from the medical professionals at QC Kinetics. Imagine this fall, moving around pain-free, doing the things you love again, like walking, hiking, and playing with the grandkids. Call QC Kinetics and see how the latest advances in precision regenerative medicine can attack your pain and bring you lasting relief. Now is the best time to get started, and they're right here in Milwaukee. Call 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. Again, 414-285-3474.
Oak Creek Lions Fest is back Friday through Labor Day, and you won't want to miss this year's lineup with three live music venues. Family fun, games, carnival rides, the Oak Creek Lions Big Money $8,000 cash raffle, helicopter rides, our craft beer tent, and the hottest in live local band favorites every day. Featuring great food with Friday's fish fry, Saturday's famous steak sandwiches and ribs, along with Sunday's ever-popular pork and beef sandwiches. And auto enthusiasts, don't miss Sunday's car show from 10 to 2. All three stages will be rocking with the hottest in local live music from DJ Red, Bella Kane, Arpers Bazaar, The Now, The Kingfish Band, Mount Olive, The Bluegrass All-Stars, and The Sensations, along with many other great bands. Don't miss the 2023 Oak Creek Lions Fest, 2 miles east of I-94, 3 blocks north of Ryan Road, and 9327 South Shepherd Avenue. Free admission, free parking. Friday through Labor Day, it's Oak Creek Lions Fest. Find out more at oakcreeklions.com, oakcreeklions.com.
Time for a WTMJ sports update. The Brewers fall to the Cubs last night at Wrigley Field. 1-0 the final. They go for the series win today, this afternoon game. First pitch around 1:20. Our coverage starts around 12:40 right here on WTMJ. Checking the Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. So far, so good. The only real issue right now is just a little slow 4145 northbound, right around the Butler area, so Hampton Avenue in that stretch. Northbound, you got a lane closed for road work there, so you'll see some slowdowns in that stretch, but you are getting through it just fine.
Traffic is brought to you by Crest Cadillac. Find them at CrestCadillac.com. Crest Cadillac of Brookfield, located on Capitol Drive, just west of Interstate 41. Discover Crest Cadillac at CrestCadillac.com.
WTMJ 5-day forecast. Becoming mostly sunny and breezy today. A high of 71, a little cooler today. A high of just 68 at the lake. Tonight, clear and cool. A low of 48 inland. Thursday, sunny and pleasant tomorrow. High of 72. Friday, a high of 80. Saturday, a high of 90. Sunday, sunny, a high of 92. Right now in Milwaukee, 61 degrees. I'm Eric Bilstead, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 10:07.
It's WTMJ Now. News, opinions, Wisconsin. Everything you need to know in the Badger State and beyond. Now, here's your hosts, Sandy Max and Steve Scafidi.
Busy first hour, Sandy, and we're just getting warmed up because we have an extended edition of the show today. Brewers game, big tilt this afternoon, big series.
Get you warmed up.
Cubs-Brewers. I should say Brewers-Cubs, since we're the flagship. Brewers-Cubs.
On their at Cubs.
Yes.
At Wrigley, which I went to Wrigley for the first time since all of the renovation.
That's
I was there
nice.
A couple of weeks ago. Wow.
Yeah.
A lot
of money.
Well done, but it certainly is, it's still... You know, it's still Wrigley kind of old-fashioned.
Yeah.
But huge screens, brand-new paint job, dark green, so it almost resembles like a Fenway vibe.
Yeah.
But I was impressed.
I'll never go after the old ballparks. Football, Lambeau Field, classic example, when they try to, you know, update their stuff, you know, make it look better, you know, obviously acknowledging technology, the big boards now that every stadium has. The cool thing is they've been able to do that and still keep some of the... You know, the hometown.
The historic vibe, yeah. You still got the ivy, you still got the bleachers, and you still got
cool.
A lot of that outdoor. Because that's also now what's special about the older stadiums is they are purely outdoor. Perfect on a summer day, not so perfect on a spring or a fall day.
That's one thing I do love about American Family Field. When we need it, the roof is invaluable. Now, there's some summer days when it's like 90 out that... You're cooking. I've sat in those seats.
That's just summer out
there. And it's summer. So
you do that up at the lake, too.
I'd rather be warm than cold. That's what I always say.
Yeah, but here's hoping for a Brewers victory today.
Yes, absolutely.
In the friendly confines.
On our flagship, the Brewers flagship, WTMJ. All right, so we're not going to spend a lot of time on this because we have a guest coming up, but I'm going to weave it through the rest of the show.
Mm.
This is the week where the pumpkin spice lattes emerge at Starbucks, right? I think it was like earlier this week or late last week. I am not a huge fan. I might have one, just to say I had one every year.
Yeah.
But I don't like have it every day. I don't have it every week.
You don't look forward to it. You don't count down.
And I don't know if you know this, because we've only been doing the show for about 5 weeks. My rule about coffee is I generally make it at home.
Mm-hmm.
But then once or twice a week, I'll go venture out and have like quick trip coffee or in the case of Starbucks, have a Starbucks coffee. Mm-hmm. Usually get a blonde, costs about $3.
Oh, that was my dad's favorite blend.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Delicious. Mm-hmm. And so I don't hate any of the coffee chains. Stone Creek, I'm at the Collectivo. I go to all of them,
but
I'm
pretty
I'm very selective in how I do that.
Okay.
So I made it my show poll today, and I'm just curious because there's all kinds of crazy associated with the pumpkin spice latte, or PSL as they call it now. It turns 20 years old this week, by the way.
You did on the 24th, yeah. Celebrated.
Does that surprise you? It surprised me.
It really did.
I thought 10, maybe.
Yeah.
20 years.
It's been a part of our lives.
Yes. So I'm just asking, and we have a couple of different questions we're going to ask you, and you can just respond throughout the show, 855-616-1620, the old National Bank Talk and Text line. Are you all in on the pumpkin spice latte or not? So I gave you a few choices. Hell no, it's not even coffee. Well, I did find out it is coffee in a... The biggest one, whatever it is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. It's got about a half a cup of coffee in it. All the rest is kind of the flavorings and all the other, you know, stuff.
And whipped cream.
Yeah, all that stuff, yeah. So it has coffee, but 39% of you say it's not even coffee. Absolutely love it. This surprised me, only 14%. And we almost have 200 votes, so 14%?
Maybe if you gave this survey in September or October, people might be more in the pumpkin spice mood.
Now, this is one of the other big choices that people are making. And I put this in because I know this is a thing.
Mm-hmm.
Pumpkin anything is a no. Like pumpkin pie, pumpkin spice. There's people that like hate pumpkins.
Not me.
I like pumpkins. I love pumpkin pie.
My boyfriend actually found a pumpkin pie at the grocery store like 2 weeks ago and brought it home for me. Some whipped cream, and that was our dessert for the week.
Now, here's how I eat
nibbling
it.
On that.
And you just put whipped cream on a cold piece of pumpkin pie, or do you warm it up?
Either or. This was room temperature.
Okay, so I warm my 20 seconds in the mic, one scoop vanilla ice cream.
Oh, ice cream makes everything better.
Oh, my, yeah, of course. Yes, but that's my
Unless
way.
Unless you're lactose intolerant, I get it, but so, if you're not,
yeah, it's the best.
A la carte, a la mode.
Yes. And I understand a pumpkin's very controversial. So if this is your chance to kind of weigh in throughout the show. We'll kind of revisit it once in a while on the pumpkin spice controversy. But here's the other question.
What?
If you were all in on the pumpkin spice thing like 20 years ago, you made some coin. Starbucks, I'm just going to say, because it's, I don't know, billions of dollars on this.
Well, and it inspired many other pumpkin spice. I've seen pumpkin spice spam. I even saw pumpkin spice trash bags. Because they were, isn't that hilarious? But you don't want your trash to smell bad, so why wouldn't you want it to smell like pumpkin spice? I thought that was pretty dang funny.
I do draw the line of pumpkin beer, not my thing.
Oh, I think you're a
Bilstead drinks it. Yeah.
Pumpkin beer. I'm all right with that.
Yeah. So that's your kind of overriding question today. Fun one for a show that has some serious pieces in it as well. 855-616-1620. Where are you on pumpkin spice? And what's the next big flavor? What's going to be the next pumpkin spice? I'm thinking like some sort of apple cinnamon thing. Although apples have been around forever, so is cinnamon.
So have pumpkins, but yeah. Apple cinnamon's a good oatmeal. Really? We're here to help.
Yeah.
If you've got the $1 million idea for what the next flavor is.
I'll kick in 100. Let's get this thing going.
Old National Bank talking text line, 855-616-1620, taking your thoughts on pumpkin spice.
All right, that's a fun one. We got a serious one coming up. And tomorrow's International Overdose Day, and we wanted to spend some time talking about the serious issue of drug use, overdose in this country. We'll have a special guest in studio after this on WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this. We heard that they have been pretty hot lately. It'd be a shame if they burned out.
Swung on, hit in the air, deep into center field. Back on it goes Taylor, back onto the track, at the wall, it is gone! William Contreras!
The Brewers are at Wrigley for a three-game series against the Cubs. Our Brewers Radio Network game day coverage starts today at 12:45. We are the home of the Brewers, 620 WTMJ. This series is sponsored by Steinhoffel's Labor Day Sale.
Hey, this is WTMJ's Steve's Committee for Advent. I had snoring issues, tossing and turning, restless nights of sleep. That was my problem. I did something about it. I went to Advent. They listened to me. They asked me questions. We did a really simple sleep study at home. They determined the root cause of my problem, my sinuses and nasal passages in my breathing triangle. Short procedure in office, in their office. Beautiful offices, by the way. I'm back to breathing well, sleeping through the whole night. That could be your story. If you struggle like we did with restless nights, tossing and turning, snoring, all of that stuff, take the time to see how Advent can help you. To find out how breathing well and sleeping well can make your nights better, go to AdventKnows.com. Simple appointment. They listened. They had a solution. Everybody's solution is different. Everybody's problem might be different, but they will take the time to find out what is yours. Go to AvidKnows.com, schedule an appointment today, because Avid knows when you breathe well, you live better.
Russ bought his first home in Wisconsin with a mortgage from Acunet when today's college freshmen were still in diapers. A few Friday mornings ago, Russ emailed saying he and his wife were ready to buy their forever home. And by 4 o'clock, we were all on a conference call with their real estate agent talking about what it would take to write a winning offer in today's inventory-starved market. And then it happened. They met their dream home face-to-face Saturday afternoon and wrote an offer $15,000 over asking, accompanied by an Acunet property-specific pre-approval letter that guaranteed they could make good on that offer without selling their existing home first and without requiring an appraisal. That's right, no appraisal required, which both the listing agent and seller loved. I can't promise your very first offer will be accepted like Russ and Julie's, but I will promise Acunet can help you and your agent craft the most attractive offer possible. Hey, don't settle for a flimsy, unimaginative bank pre-approval. Get started with your rock-solid, guaranteed pre-approval by clicking on the blue button today at accunet.com.
WTMJ Now.
Hey, welcome back. Listening to WTMJ Now. Thanks for tuning in. However you find us over the air, online, the stream. We got lots going on. Producer Charlie working his butt off back there. Sandy Max alongside. Special guest in studio. We noted earlier that tomorrow's a very important day. International Overdose Day. And that is a problem that affects all of us, all of our families. I don't think you could find a person in this country, this great country of ours, that hasn't been touched by this problem, the scourge of our country. Joining us from Clean Slates, Katrina Jenkins, Center Manager, Danielle Wegman, Community Relations Liaison. Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It's great to have you in the studio. Let's start with this. Obviously, the overdose story is something that's covered extensively on local TV, national TV. I guess let's get a baseline. How bad is this problem? Is it trending up, down? Where are we at, Katrina?
Trending up.
Unfortunately.
Unfortunately.
So why is that? The big question.
You know, we have to remember that addiction is a disease.
Yes.
And so when you look at the state that we're in, you know, people don't have jobs, people, education, you know, family history, and just where we're at in 2023, the disease is out there, and we have to help people and get people into places that their disease can be treated.
I have friends, close friends, who have lost family members, sons, daughters from drug abuse, and in some cases, one or two time, you know, trying something and being seriously impacted, including death. The individual story is one that that always touches me. When we talk about a national problem, overdose, and there's a lot of things we'll get into about, you know, helping people and how we can sort of try to overcome this. When you hear those individual stories, as somebody who works in that field and works in that area, how do you not take that home with you every day? I mean, it's got to be just so depressing.
You have to do self-care for yourself, because you're not going to be effective and help those in need if you take that home. And one of the things that Clean Slate stresses is for myself, Danielle, the providers, the support staff, we have to take care of ourselves, whether it's a massage, whether it's taking vacation, but we have to treat ourselves so we can continue to treat our patients.
Danielle, what's on this day tomorrow, International Overdose Day, what are we telling people? What's the messaging tomorrow?
I think the major message is to help destigmatize the disease of addiction. I want to add that to one of the major factors as to why it's such a problem today is because of the stigma tied to it. People usually blame the individual who is facing the addiction, and people need to realize it is chemically going on in their brains, this addiction that's happening with them, whether it's with opioids or alcohol or gambling even. So that's just something that people need to kind of reframe that mindset, much like people who have the disease of diabetes or anything like that.
I think with International Overdose Awareness Day, one of the most shocking statistics that I saw on your Clean Slate website, that in 2021, fentanyl overdoses, the number one cause of death of Americans 18 to 45. Just jaw-dropping. When you talk about addiction being a disease, we think of cancer just being this terrible disease. This is right up there. How are people getting fentanyl?
Well, the thing about fentanyl is it can be laced in a lot of drugs. So you could be smoking marijuana and it could be laced with fentanyl and you wouldn't know it. You could be buying, you know, opiates on the street and it's laced with fentanyl and you wouldn't know that. So we were happy as an organization, as many of our other people that we work with in the community were, when Governor Evers signed the bill that fentanyl test strips were no longer drug paraphernalia. So you wouldn't be arrested if you had the fentanyl test strips. You know, and right now you can go to any Milwaukee County Fire Police Department, not police department, sorry, fire department, and ask for a HOPE kit. And in that HOPE kit are fentanyl test strips. So that if you're not quite ready for recovery and you're still using, you can test what you're about to take. So you would know if there's fentanyl in there.
What kind of resources are there for people when they realize, okay, I'm in a dangerous situation, or for families of people who are concerned about those people? Are there Wisconsin resources?
Absolutely. There are a great number of them, I would say, which is great because everyone needs different options. Not one option is going to work for everyone. So we, as Clean Slate, we're just one of the addiction treatment options in the community. You know, right away, I would say it would be beneficial for folks to learn about and carry Narcan, as well as those test strips that Katrina talked about, just to be ready and at a moment's notice, be prepared when someone might have that overdose.
We are joined by Daniel Wegman, Katrina Jenkins, Center Manager at Clean Slate. Are you having an event tomorrow on Awareness Day, or what's going on with your community?
So we partner with community partners. So tomorrow we will be at Samad's house, and that's one event. And the second event is at UMO. So we're trying to cover all of the city. Samad's house on North 23rd Street. UMass is on the south side on Chase. And then we're ending the day at Mitchell Park with a walk and releasing lanterns for the loved ones who have passed away due to overdose.
The website is www.cleanslatescenters.com. This question came up. What advice would you give people who are just starting this process? They have a family member that's maybe in trouble. They have concerns. What's the best piece of advice you could give them?
I would say educate yourself on the options and make yourself aware of them. So then when that person is ready to maybe seek treatment, because sometimes the first time might not work, it might take a couple of times, and that's okay. It's their journey. Just be educated on the different resources in the community. Again, us being one of many. So just kind of see what's out there and what works, because we do medicated assisted treatment. Sometimes that might not work for people in the spectrum of harm reduction versus, you know, 100% sobriety. But again, it's just per the individual and their needs.
The day is International Overdose Awareness Day. It is something that so many people are affected by. I want to thank you guys for the great work that you do. Katrina Jenkins, Danielle Wegman. When you show up at work every day, is every day different? Is it the same every day? What's the experience like?
Every day is different, and every day a patient shows up for their appointment is a good day. And we do celebrate all of their milestones. And it may be that, you know, I've been in recovery and I don't have any illicit substances in my body for a week. It may be 90 days. It might be a year. It may be a mom who now regained custody of her children because she is truly in recovery.
Those are the success stories.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you guys should be lauded for the work that you do, and why there's hope, because obviously we see the negative and we hear the negative so much when these stories are talked about. And, you know, I asked you that trend question earlier, but the great thing about any trend, it can be flipped around and turned a different way. So I appreciate the great work that you guys are doing. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you. Absolutely.
Thanks for having us.
International Overdose Awareness Day tomorrow, and thanks to the great work by the folks of Clean Slate. Danielle Wegman, Katrina Jenkins. We'll take a break. You're listening to WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this.
Be our eyes on the road. See something out there that I should know about?
Hi, there is an accident on I-43 northbound.
Call me, Debbie Lozaga, at the HallMazda.com traffic tip line at 414 414-
238-9329.
Hi, Debbie. It's Michael. Just drove through the area of 894 West. There's debris in the roadway.
The drive affects you. Why not be part of it?
I'm sitting here in I-43 North, north of Silver Spring at the parking lot.
Give me a call. 414-238-9329.
Business insurance continues to get more expensive. To share his knowledge on the topic and the impact, here's Jeff Salasinski, VP Insurance Operations at R&R Insurance.
Thanks, Vince. Volatile weather, inflationary pressures, and cybercrime are driving insurance costs up for everyone today. It's important to be concerned with cost, but don't make the critical mistake of buying insurance on price alone. Critical mistakes we see and correct for buyers regularly include policies with big gaps in coverage, and not applying discounts and credits the buyer's eligible for. R&R Insurance will get you a competitive price and a policy with all the key coverages and limits. Are you certain your policy will protect you and your business in the event of a loss?
So, Jeff, what's the solution?
With 48 years of stability, local family ownership, and deep industry knowledge, R&R Insurance will be focused on you and your success. And the best part, we're not for sale. At R&R Insurance, we know business insurance.
That's Jeff from R&R Insurance. Thanks for the great info, Jeff.
Don't miss out on the Labor Day sale at Ken Michaels Furniture. Our entire showroom of heirloom quality furniture is on sale. Enjoy an unprecedented 37% off Norwalk furniture, as well as 40% off Bradington Young and Hooker furniture. Create a sofa or chair as unique as you are with our thousands of customizable upholstery options. If you want spectacular discounts on their heirloom quality furniture, shop the Labor Day sale now at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee. There's no doubt that a better night's sleep makes for better days, and a good quality mattress helps make it happen. When you buy your new Milwaukee mattress from Ken Michaels Furniture, you are assured of a mattress made individually for you out of the finest materials right from our own Milwaukee factory. We make every style, size, and firmness of mattress imaginable. And with our factory direct prices, you will save hundreds of dollars. Milwaukee mattresses from Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee. Where better days come from a great night's sleep.
It's WTMJ Now.
Thanks to Clean Slate. Danielle and Katrina coming in the studio to talk about International Overdose Awareness Day tomorrow. It's one of those stories that, you know, it's covered, you see it a lot in the national news. The trends are always horrible, and, you know, the big one, of course, fentanyl, all those drugs coming across our border, and that's a whole nother conversation.
And we just saw on the news just this past week, the African-American young officer who was searching a car picked up a blue sweater, and he felt it immediately, and the way he described the feeling was terrifying. He was mentally all there, but his body was frozen. And his partner responded immediately, and another officer came over and shot Narcan up his nose while they're standing in the median on I-43. You know, it was really sobering and terrifying to see how fast it happened and how this fit young man was immediately paralyzed physically and how fast that works.
And I've told the story before, and I keep it anonymous as I can, but I have a friend who lost two sons to drug overdoses.
Oh, my.
And, you know, we can all think we know what that feels like. When you have three kids and two of them are gone because of drugs, that's going to change, and it has changed, both him and his wife. It's a reality that I hope that we understand how serious it is, but I don't know that we do, because it's kind of like, well, that's somebody else's problem. Well, it is until it affects you or impacts you. So I don't want to be one of those people. You know, I was lucky. My daughters didn't present those kind of problems, and they've gone on to successful careers and lives and families. But that's not everybody's story. When you have organizations, and they're one of many, and Danielle and Katrina dropped off a list. They have outpatient offices all over our area: Kenosha, Janesville, Green Bay, La Crosse, Madison, Sheboygan, Racine, Glendale, and they're one of many that do this service. So I don't want the day to just happen without us at least thinking about this in a different way than just a headline that this many people died.
And I feel like Danielle Wegman, the community relations liaison of Clean Slate Center, said it very well and applies to a lot of different issues that people struggle with, but the stigma, and that if you yourself are feeling like you're getting out of control, it is super okay to reach out to a center, to get help, reach out to a family member, friend, but it's that stigma that prevents a lot of people from getting help and leads to overdoses. If you're keeping that part of your life secret and not dealing with it, that can lead to terrible, terrible things like an overdose.
Yeah, I love the fact that Katrina talked about success stories as well.
Yeah.
People that are, they are meeting their benchmarks. They are coming in and sharing those stories. Another quick one, again, anonymous. I had another close couple friend of ours whose son got involved with drugs early after high school. And his addiction was heroin.
Mm.
Ended up stealing, getting arrested, ended up killing himself at a very young age. And in the process, this is why this stuff matters. This is why intervention, getting involved early matters. His parents were basically wiped out financially because they did all those things the parents were supposed to do. They wanted to get him help. You know, they had to take tons of money out of their savings and their 401ks to pay for that treatment. And in the end, it didn't work. Those are real stories that people are facing every day. So we can ignore it and say it's not our problem. But in fact, it is. This is happening around us all the time. And that's just two people that I know. What about all the people that I don't know and that are facing these challenges every day? So we will probably mark the day tomorrow as well, International Overdose Awareness Day, because it's significant in a country that's dealing with a fentanyl epidemic.
Mm-hmm.
This is something we got to pay attention to. We'll take a break. It's 10:31 WTMJ Now. We have a lot on our plate. We have an extended show today because of the early Brewers game. I think it's about 1:10 first pitch, but we'll be out of here about 12:40-ish, I will say. Some fun stuff, some serious stuff. And don't forget our regular Wednesday feature, 11 o'clock hour. Ask us anything. You get to dictate where we go. I love this hour. And I'm guessing some of it will go to politics since we spent some time talking about Hunter Biden this morning. And keep those texts coming, by the way. I'm reading them. Sandy's reading them. We always love to hear from you. We'll take a break. We'll get back to it. Back to the business of WTMJ Now after this.
Sandy and Steve will be back after this.
Where are we putting that money, and why are we putting it there? At Financial Strategies, you'll get answers to those questions to understand our approach. And the answers are going to be based on what we've learned about you. We're very engaged with our clients so that what we do for them fits their particular needs. But there are other things that we do that are equally important to the investment management portion of our services. I can't express how important it is to control the things you can control. At the end of the day, most investment managers will end up yielding similar overall returns. But knowing how to manage them wisely to avoid your nest egg being eaten away by the tax man, all legally, of course, well, that's what I truly believe sets us apart. This is Jim Cantrell with Financial Strategies, Inc., and we can show you a wiser way to build your wealth. So go to financialstrategiesinc.com and schedule a no-cost consultation.
Financial Strategies, a wiser way to build your wealth.
Did you know you can get your prescriptions for less at your local pharmacy? You can with GoodRx. It's the free app that can save you money on your medications. Just search for your prescription, choose the pharmacy and the price that works best for you, and then show your GoodRx coupon to your pharmacist at the drop-off counter. GoodRx works at over 70,000 pharmacies, including Walmart, Rite Aid, and Walgreens, and it works whether you have insurance or not. It's easy to save. Next time you drop off your prescription, check GoodRx. To start saving today, go to GoodRx.com. GoodRx is not insurance.
Think identity theft won't happen to you? Think again. There's a new victim every 3 seconds in the U.S., over 15 million this year alone, and many don't even know they're victims. LifeLock alerts you to identity threats you could miss, even when you monitor your credit. If your identity is stolen, your dedicated U.S.-based restoration specialist will work to fix it. No one can prevent all identity theft, but everyone can save up to 25% off their first year with promo code NEWS at LifeLock.com. Identity theft protection starts here.
WTMJ Now.
I always love to give the texters some time on the show because they've taken the time to actually text the show and listen to the segments that we put forward. This is from the 414, Sandy. I'm an ER nurse for many years. The amount of overdoses we treat has tripled. Where do you think the amount of strong fentanyl is coming from? We have wide open borders. Some of the strongest fentanyl is coming in. Of course, mainstream media is hush-hush, as well as yourself. So I'll take the bait. I'm not hush about it at all. What I will tell you, though, politics, again, comes back to politics, has destroyed the honest intellectual debate about border policy. Because what happens? They endlessly argue, both sides, about what's the right policy? What do we do on the border? And nothing happens. Doesn't matter if we have a Republican administration. Last one was Trump. Current administration, Joe Biden. They messed the bed. Yes, fentanyl is coming across that border. Should we allow that? No. I'm a guy who sits here and says we should have strict border policy. But we've allowed politicians to destroy the debate. So therefore, we have to suffer the consequences, which in this case is fentanyl pouring across our border. What do you want me to do about it? Other than tell you, if you're going to play politics as a sport on the radio, on TV, in your real life, with your relationships, this is what you get. Inaction, and in this case, deadly inaction, because drugs are pouring across the border. Now, could some of that be overstated? Sure. But I've had enough law enforcement folks on the show, Sandy, and they're telling me this is a problem. Therefore, I would agree with them. There's no easy answers to this stuff, but the easiest answer is, if you have a flow of drugs coming into your country that you don't want, are illegal and are deadly, you probably want to do your best to stop those. It's kind of common sense and logic. So while I certainly appreciate your work as an ER nurse, and I'm not doubting the fact that overdoses have tripled, which is why we just spent 15 minutes talking to people who actually know what they're talking about when it comes to drugs and overdose and treatments, the folks from Clean Slate who joined us in studio. I would say that's an example of media doing the right thing, talking about an issue that's important. Ask yourself, if you're a consumer of talk radio, how many other shows are going to talk about International Overdose Awareness Day? Ask yourself, and then listen. Listening makes you smarter, believe it or not. And I'm somebody who is a bad listener who's trying to improve every day.
Thank you.
Yes.
And also giving you resources, because Clean Slate is around all over Wisconsin, which is good. And it's one thing to talk about it and complain about it, but there are ways to get help and encourage you, if you do need help, to reach out, because stigma really does keep this in the secret spaces and underground, and it's hard to get help when you're hiding.
Yeah. From the 414, hey, Steve, I agree the border is politics. With that said, where are the courts in enforcing our laws? I believe the prior administration was trying to do that, weren't they? I'm not saying they weren't, but here we are. The problem is not that we can't figure it out. We can if we want to. The problem is when we have differences between parties, differences in how we approach the problem without consensus, which, sorry, Mike Pence, but consensus is leadership, you're going to get a haphazard, this is what we're doing, this is what we're doing, back and forth. It's not helpful. It doesn't stop the flow of drugs. So my answer is simple. Get some consistency from both parties. That's what will make a difference. Rick from Norway. Hey, Stephen, Sandy, I agree and disagree. It won't matter what border policy you have. Fentanyl, along with other legal drugs, will get across our border in this country no matter what. I don't think so. I'm certainly not going to accept that, Sandy. Why would I accept that? If it's a bad thing, shouldn't we do everything we can to stop the bad thing from happening, right? Or do we just let mayhem ensue and just have kangaroo courts and guys walking around with tech vests they bought on the internet enforcing our laws? No, I'm not signing up for that. Institutions matter. Enforcement matters. Lastly, Rick says, and that's been demonstrated by 50 to 100 years of this activity. There's a market for drugs, trust me.
I would say follow the money.
Yeah. I mean, there's some ideas. I think, I'm not sure if I'm all in on this, but make the use of drugs not an illegal activity. There's people that have proposed that. Is that the answer? I don't know. You certainly see what marijuana laws.
I say probably not in this state based on where we are watching all of our border states deal with legalized marijuana.
We're an island. Canada, Minnesota, Illinois, Michigan, and 38 other states have at least gone down that road. And we sit here and we argue, mostly about politics, about that issue. And that's just marijuana. We can't get beyond our own lack of imagination, lack of innovation, lack of leadership to figure out any of the serious problems that we're having in this country, because that's the arguments we want to have. All right, we're going to shift gears after the break. Sandy, Steve, WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this.
Is joint pain, soreness, and achiness getting in the way of your best life? Football legend Emmitt Smith refuses to back down to pain. That's why he's a huge advocate for QC Kinetics and their natural approach to getting you relief.
Look, we get one trip around. So I wouldn't ever let pain stop me from hanging out with my race team, traveling with my family, or golfing with my friends.
Emmett's got it right. And QC Kinetics uses regenerative medicine to relieve that never-ending pain in your knees, hips, shoulders, and back. And the best news, there's nothing foreign being introduced into your body. Just your own body's natural healing properties. No surgery or no downtime.
If pain's holding you back, maybe it's tennis, pickleball, running, hiking, or spending time with special people in your life, what are you waiting for? This is precious time. Get out there and get over to QC Kinetics.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
In this market, you'll find Fisher Investments is different than other money managers.
Different how? Aren't we all just looking for the hottest stocks?
Nope. We use diversified strategies to position our clients' portfolios for their long-term goals.
You don't just provide cookie-cutter portfolios?
No. We tailor our clients' portfolios to their goals and needs.
But you still sell investments that generate high commissions for you, right?
No, we don't sell commission-based products. We're a fiduciary, the highest standard of care for a financial advisor. It means we're obligated to act in our clients' best interest.
So when do you make more money? Only when your clients make more money?
Yep, we have one transparent management fee structured so we do better when our clients do better.
Sounds like you really look out for your clients.
We do, because our priority is helping them achieve a comfortable retirement. That might be why most of our clients come from other money managers. Visit FisherInvestments.com to find out why investors like you switch to us. Fisher Investments. Clearly, different money management.
Investments and securities involve the risk of loss.
The new Raid Essentials Light Trap uses light to attract, then trap, flying insects like fruit flies and mosquitoes. For insecticide protection that's people and pet friendly, get new Raid Essential Light Trap.
Russ bought his first home in Wisconsin with a mortgage from Acunet when today's college freshmen were still in diapers. A few Friday mornings ago, Russ emailed saying he and his wife were ready to buy their forever home. And by 4 o'clock, we were all on a conference call with their real estate agent talking about what it would take to write a winning offer in today's inventory-starved market. And then it happened. They met their dream home face-to-face Saturday afternoon and wrote an offer $15,000 over asking, accompanied by an Acunet property-specific pre-approval letter that guaranteed they could make good on that offer without selling their existing home first and without requiring an appraisal. That's right, no appraisal required, which both the listing agent and seller loved. I can't promise your very first offer will be accepted like Russ and Julie's, but I will promise Acunet can help you and your agent craft the most attractive offer possible. Hey, don't settle for a flimsy, unimaginative bank pre-approval. Get started with your rock-solid, guaranteed pre-approval by clicking on the blue button today at accunet.com.
It's WTMJ Now.
Oh, Diana Ross coming to town. How about that? All this week, Sandy, we're giving away a pair of tickets to go see Diana Ross. Legendary, iconic, diva.
Yes, all of the above.
Singer extraordinaire.
Miller High Life Theater, September 10th. If you've never seen her, yeah. If you've never seen her, make it this a bucket list item, because you never know when it's your last chance to see a legend. And she will impress for all the way from her songs with the Supremes back in the Motown years of the 60s and her solo work. We just heard more of her 80s music. She's just unstoppable.
Don't do what I did. I passed up a chance to see Frank Sinatra to go to a Cubs game. Bad choice. And he was gone like a year or so, or a couple years after that. I did see Tony Bennett, though, at the, I think it was the Riverside.
Well done.
Thing about Tony Bennett, not that I want to get away from Diana Ross, he, at one point, and this was probably, I think, 5 or 6 years ago, maybe a little bit longer than that, I think I still have the recording, he puts the microphone down on the piano, steps forward on stage, and sings a song without the aid of a microphone to a packed house, and you could hear every word perfectly.
That's how Broadway used to do it. That was called projecting your voice.
Unbelievable. The guy, I mean, he had obviously one of the most, to overuse the term, iconic voices in music. But Diana Ross is amazing. I've never seen her. And you said you
My mom and I went to see her at Chicago Theater probably 15 years ago. Because my mom grew up in the Michigan area and really grew up listening to her. Yeah. And it was epic. And she does have wardrobe changes, which you can enjoy as well. But she truly is that definition of a diva. They would pipe and drape the walkway so you couldn't see her backstage in her outfits. Like, she didn't want to be seen. She wanted to have that reveal.
think she'll do that?
I don't know backstage. We can find out. Yeah. But see her on stage if you'd like to win a pair of tickets right now. Do we have some callers?
Yeah, we don't have callers yet because we have to give out the number 855-616-1620. That's on me. I should have gave it out before the break. So start hitting those phone lines. 855-616-1620.
Trivia question.
Very specific
question.
You're
willing to play.
This will be the day where the phone lines don't work.
I'm not.
There we go. Now they're starting. Oh, you asked.
There we go.
They're all lighting up now. So
yesterday's trivia question was incredibly easy. It was basically, what is this song?
And I didn't know the answer to it. It was upside down.
Yeah.
And I don't know the answer to today's question
upside
either.
Upside Down was her biggest number one hit.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. As soon as we have some names on these phone lines, we'll start. Oh, there we go. Linda from New Berlin is first up. Sandy's going to ask you a question. Be prepared to answer it, and you may win two tickets to see Diana Ross in September. Linda, oh, let me get her in. Hi, Linda.
Great. Hi.
How are you?
Can you hear me?
Absolutely.
Yes. Can you hear me?
I can hear you.
Good, because I've got the question for you. Today's trivia question to win a pair of tickets to see Diana Ross September 10th at Miller High Life Theater. You know she's incredibly accomplished. How many Grammy Awards has Diana Ross won?
Oh, my gosh. 8.
Lower than that.
It's lower than that?
Lower than that.
Interesting. I would have guessed higher. Okay, thanks for the call, Linda.
Thanks, Linda. Thanks for playing. My one hint is that it's an obscene amount.
Roger from West Bend is next up. All right, hopefully you heard that, Roger. So it's lower than 8.
I'm going to try 6.
Lower than that. Thanks for playing.
I got it. Count me as shocked. All
right. All right.
Thanks
too.
Thanks for the call, Roger. Oh, let's see. Kathy calling from Madison. Hi, Kathy. Good morning.
Hello.
Hi, Kathy.
Good morning.
How many Grammy Awards has Diana Ross won?
4.
Less than that.
Come on!
Thank you for playing.
Nuts.
I love the honesty from Kathy. Bill from Muskego. Hey, Bill.
Bill, are you there?
Hello.
There's only 3 numbers left, so you got a good champ.
Bill, how many Grammy Awards has Diana Ross been awarded?
I got to say 0.
Can you say that again?
0.
Unfortunately, absolutely right. Isn't that shocking? Oh. She's been nominated 13 times, and she won a Lifetime Achievement Award in 2012. But for all of those 13 Grammy nominations, didn't win.
That isn't, Bill, did you know that or just guess?
No, that's a big surprise. I just kind of threw it out there as a guess.
Wow. Good guess.
But that's
Bill.
Why I said it's obscene.
I don't get that.
She's got the Lifetime Achievement Award, but I just would have thought that out of 13 nominations between her work with the Supremes and solo, she would have won.
Bill, stay on the line. Our producer Charlie to get all your important information and have fun at the Diana Ross show.
Yeah. I want to hear your concert review.
If she was performing, like, let's just, she started her career like last year. There's no way she's winning 0. There's no way. I mean, that makes no sense whatsoever. Does it?
Well, that's what awards are. They're all subjective, right? And I could dig deep and find out what she, you know, the songs and albums that she just lost to. That's always interesting when it comes to Grammys, like who best new artist is. Who's
the soap opera actress who was nominated?
Susan Lucci.
Yeah.
So she's kind of the Susan Lucci of Grammys. Yeah. I could see that.
But she eventually did win one, Susan Lucci.
Ah.
Yeah, so she cashed in at some point.
Yeah, but Diana Ross, an incredible night of music. You can win free tickets again tomorrow and Friday. Yeah. You can also just go ahead and get your tickets. Miller High Life Theater, September 10th, to see Diana Ross.
2 more chances to win. I want to get back to the pumpkin spice thing quickly because somebody asked me a question about that. Gas prices. I'm reading that gas prices may drop below $3. Oh, my goodness. What are we going to whine about if gas prices go below $3? I don't know. We'll answer that question after this. You're listening, of course, to WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this. Stay in touch. You can reach us on the old National Bank talk and text line at 855-616-1620. Old National Bank. Get old.
You're just going to have to live with it. That's what I told myself. And if you can believe it, that's what the doctors told me.
Since Andy was a boy, he had health issues, which later we would find were primarily due to his trouble breathing. So for 36 years, Andy lived with about 85% blockage in his nose. He had to breathe through his mouth, because when he tried to breathe through his nose, it felt like he was being suffocated. It affected his sleep, his work life, and his ability to play sports. And he wasn't going to let it ruin his life anymore. So he came to Advent. As bad as it was, his problem required a simple solution. In-office balloon sinuplasty and turbinate reduction. Procedures you won't find offered by big box healthcare. This is Dr. Madan Kandula. It's definitely possible that your nasal breathing problems have a simple solution too. You can hear Andy's story in his own words at AdventKnowsAndy.com and begin on your path to breathing well and living better.
Results may vary.
Annex Wealth Management. Investment, retirement, tax, and estate planning from a fee-only fiduciary. Forgive commission sales pitches and financial products you don't need. Know the difference. Annex provides elite, comprehensive financial planning customized to who you are and what you need. AnnexWealth.com.
The Brewers Pennant race is heating up. Make sure you have a spot when October comes around. Get first dibs at postseason tickets with your 2024 season ticket plan. Not only will you get first access to Brewers postseason tickets, but season seat holders only enjoy exclusive benefits, the best seats, big savings on tickets, exclusive rewards, and more. Place a deposit now to be a part of the postseason and beyond at brewers.com/season tickets.
John Deere and Horicon is hiring press operators. Nothing beats their wage and benefits package. Full-time press operators pay no premiums for family health insurance, meaning they can take home hundreds more each month. With $23 to $25 per hour to start, a $1,000 sign-on bonus, annual wage increases, potential bonuses, 401k with company match, and more, nothing says you've arrived like a job at John Deere Horicon Works. So apply now at deere.com/horicon.
WTMJ, W277-CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
WTMJ Now.
Officially 20 years of the pumpkin spice latte. Some would say a nightmare. Some would say I love pumpkin spice. My show poll, our show poll is asking the question today, are you all in on the PSL or no? Hell no, not even coffee, 38%. Absolutely love it, 12%. That number's going down, by the way. Pumpkin anything is a no. That's 38%. That's leading right now, or tied for the lead. A few comments. Some factoids about pumpkin spice lattes.
Okay.
Starbucks sells, guess how many of these, I'll just ask you, how many do they sell every year? It's mind-boggling.
Well, you have to think how many cups of coffee they sell, period.
Yeah, it's, billions.
Yeah, I would say, considering there's one still on every other block.
Mm-hmm.
It's a lot.
It's 600 million.
Wow.
That blew me away. I was expecting, maybe like 600 million pumpkin spice. That's how crazy
this
is.
And that's why they're going to keep selling them.
You know how big the industry is? Pumpkin-flavored products? Almost what was the number?
Billion, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's of course, when I want to see it, I can't find it. Where is it, my number? 803.
803 million.
Yeah.
Almost a billion.
Yeah.
You love your metrics.
Yes, I do. I mean, because I think it's important, but I'm still curious. What's the next thing? Because there's always a next thing, right? There's always a next thing.
And that's what I would love. We have very smart WTMJ fans. We've seen it time and time again on the talk and text line. Old National Bank talk and text line, 855-616-1620. Honestly, in your kitchen, what is the next flavor?
What could it be, though? I mean,
something in nutmeg, pumpkin spice?
What's that, like that ice cream drink? That has nutmeg on top? Is it Brandy Alexander? I think so. Yeah, I mean.
Maybe that's the next flavor, an old-fashioned?
How about this?
Old-fashioned coffee?
I don't think Starbucks has done, or any, maybe they have, maybe they haven't. So we have pumpkin beer and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. What about alcohol-infused, like, I don't think Starbucks has gone, like, full Bailey's and coffee yet, right? Because that's a popular drink.
Well, I think they'd have to rezone every single store.
Of course, liquor license.
So I don't think that's...
But could that be a thing? Because I love a Bailey's and coffee. You kidding me? I love them.
So non-alcoholic Bailey's and coffee.
Oh, I'm saying alcohol. Might as well go all in. We love alcohol in this state.
Just identified that they would have to get a liquor license every single location. So that's why I'm going to...
Yeah, you're saying
I am not usually an idea killer, but if you're saying a mocktail coffee?
How about that? A non-alcoholic Bailey's and coffee.
Then that sounds practical.
Is that an industry that could take off like the pumpkin spice latte industry?
Why not?
I would buy one. I See, that's my thing. I try one every year, pumpkin spice latte, because I think I forget how at some point it's just like nasty. And I like pumpkin, but pumpkin spice latte has maybe too much spice, not enough pumpkin. Remember the whole controversy?
Have you not been to a Starbucks? You can customize it. I'm sure you can say light on the pumpkin.
Somebody was telling me, actually it was a buddy of mine on Twitter, was saying he orders a quad espresso every day. What would a quad espresso do to you?
Zip it around. He's getting stuff done.
And no one mats like I do. I think that's probably why he's like the way he is.
Your nutmeg ice cream drink is a Tom and Jerry.
According
to Mike and Whitewater and a few other WTMJ
I'm
fans.
I'm trying to remember my old bartending days at a supper club, Ray Bussler's Supper Club, which is not there anymore, on 27th Street in Oakwood and Oak Creek. And I was a bartender when I was 18, and all I made was Manhattans, martinis, and ice cream drinks. And if you have a full bar and people start ordering ice cream drinks, because you know what happens? It's contagious.
Yeah.
That's the last thing you want to be doing, because the Manhattan martinis aren't stopping. You got to make those too. And then you got ice cream drinks to make, and you're working by yourself on a Friday night, and you don't even want to be there because you want to be out with your friends.
Sure.
Craziness when it comes to alcohol. All right, one other quick one. I'm curious what you think about this. So much of our political angst and anger is about how much things cost right now, right? So Bidenomics on one side, blow up Joe Biden on the other side. He's the reason why all these things cost more, inflation, all the recession, the R word, all that stuff.
I still remember when people go, thanks, Obama.
Yeah.
Like it'd be anything, like your shoe came untied.
Yeah.
Thanks, Obama.
Thanks, Obama. So there's a strong professional opinion by people who monitor gas prices that by the end of the year, part of it's consumption, part of it's just the reality of the markets. We're seeing some of our supplies increase. Gas per gallon could be below $3. Do you think, Sandy Max, that will silence all the folks who have basically used that as a political talking point for the last 3 years to blow up Joe Biden? What about gas prices? They put stickers on the gas pumps. You've seen these, right? I did this, the Joe Biden stickers they put on gas pumps, and they point to the price when it was $4 or whatever it was.
No,
it's a real thing.
I didn't see that.
Oh, real thing. I saw it at a local gas station in Oak Creek.
Jeez.
So will that silence?
That's amusing, but...
It is amusing. Will that silence all these critics who just basically look at gas prices as the way that you judge America and the conduct and the actions?
Well, again, it's selective memory. I like to think, it's selective memory. And I would also caution that gas prices are very likely to go up in the next bit. I know they went up 30 cents in my neighborhood just yesterday. This hurricane is probably going to halt some production in Florida.
Hopefully
and
not.
Up and down the Gulf Coast. So expect them to go up a bit, and plus with Labor Day. So I don't know if we'll see lower gas prices at the end of the year. I like the idea of that.
I do too.
The thing that makes me laugh is when there are people who will argue, well, gas prices were really low in 2020. Well, you know why? Because a whole bunch of people weren't driving around.
Yeah, there was no zero demand.
So it's like, so you can't make that comparison. Can you make a comparison since 2021 to now? Maybe, but when people say, yeah, well, gas prices were the lowest ever in 2020 under certain administrations, it's like, yes, because no one was driving.
Let me answer my own question.
Okay.
It won't make any difference to anybody. They'll still complain about something because that's what we do. I love this from the 262 on my question about maybe there's an alcohol or an alcohol-free version of something we could do.
We're off of gas then. Okay.
Yes. My wife calls her Bailey's and coffee her weekend creamer.
Ah.
Interesting. Well, yeah, why not? My drink of choice early mornings in Las Vegas when I'm sliding up to a blackjack table about 7:30 or 8 in the morning when no one else is around other than me and the dealer and chips is a Bailey's and coffee. I have a couple of those. Starts the day off in a great way.
The flavor could be pumpkin wine from the 414 on Old National Bank. Talking text line 855-616-1620. My dad made pumpkin wine when I was young. I remember it was sweet and it made my ears hot with one tiny sip.
I can honestly say I've never had pumpkin wine. You can make wine out of anything. My grandma used to make dandelion wine, which I always thought, oof. I know people eat dandelion, the ones that aren't treated with chemicals. They're like salad.
Salad.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
Yeah. Escarole, sort of. Last one, Michelle. Not only are ice cream drinks contagious, everyone will order a different one. That's the thing. You want to focus, and you got people ordering, yelling different drink orders.
Yeah.
It's maniac time. Stop doing that. But I do like a good ice cream. Give me a good grasshopper. Delicious. Probably have one once a year, but you have a good grasshopper made by a real bartender.
Yeah.
Woo, that's good.
Let's go. All right. Pink squirrel.
Let's tee it up after the news, which is next on WTMJ. Ask us anything, 855-616-1620. It could go anywhere today. Who knows? That's how we're going to spend our next hour. Expanded edition of the show today. The news is next on WTMJ.
More of WTMJ now after this.
Don't miss out on the Labor Day sale at Ken Michaels Furniture. Our entire showroom of heirloom quality furniture is on sale. Enjoy an unprecedented 37% off Norwalk furniture, as well as 40% off Bradington Young and Hooker furniture. Create a sofa or chair as unique as you are with our thousands of customizable upholstery options. If you want spectacular discounts on their heirloom quality furniture, shop the Labor Day sale now at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee. Do you love the simplicity and enduring quality of Scandinavian design? Then the Fjords Labor Day Sale at Ken Michaels Furniture is for you. Inspired by tradition and built to last, Fjords brings the best modern Norwegian furniture design to your home. Save up to 20% on these ergonomic recliners engineered with comfort in mind. Available in a variety of shapes, sizes, leathers, and finishes to match any decor. Stop in today during our Labor Day Sale at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee. Sale ends soon.
Ah, nothing like a late summer dust up with an old foe.
On the ground, left side, tough play! Safe! Ball game over!
The I-94 rivalry heats up as the Brewers travel south for a clash with the Cubs.
The Cubs get their hearts broken again.
The Brewers-Cubs series is sponsored by Steinhoffel's Labor Day Sale. Our Brewers-Cubs coverage gets underway beginning at 12:45. We are your home of the Brewers. 620 WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 11:01, 62 degrees the high today, 71 inland, sunny and breezy. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Eric Bilstead.
This is real. This is for real. Don't take it lightly. We want you to be safe.
The governor of Savannah, or I'm sorry, the mayor of Savannah, Georgia, as Hurricane Idalia now moves its way into Georgia. The storm made landfall earlier this morning, pushing 125 miles per hour.
That makes Idalia a powerful Category 3 storm, the strongest to hit the Big Bend region since 1896.
I went through the storm of 1993, storm of the century.
That man lives in Keaton Beach, Florida, near the point of Idalia's landfall. He evacuated and headed inland, and now
I don't know if I'm going to have a house to go home to.
Idalia is blamed for at least one fatality. The driver of a pickup truck in Pasco County lost control during the storm, crashed into a tree, and was killed instantly. Jim Ryan, ABC News, Tampa.
Idalia now a Category 1 hurricane as it moves over landfall. Here at home, a new city report finds that Capitol Drive is by far the most dangerous road in Milwaukee. Robert Bradford has owned a barbershop on Capitol for 20 years. He tells CMJ4 News.
Sad to say, I'm kind of immune to seeing all the car accidents and the motorcycle accidents. Just on the next block here, there was a car to run right directly into the laundromat and hit a kid.
This year so far, there have been 5 fatal crashes along Capitol Drive. Milwaukee's 11th District Alderman, Mark Borkowski, says he's not going to seek re-election next year. Borkowski, a former county supervisor, was elected to the Common Council in 2015. County Supervisor Peter Berkelis and Lee Whiting, a member of the City's Safety and Civic Commission, have said they plan to run for that seat. A Brady Street bar is picking up the tab on Sundays this football season.
That's if and only if Aaron Rodgers' New York Jets lose. Jack's American Pub Director of Operations Ryan Cook tells Wisconsin's Afternoon News how the idea came about.
Well, we knew there was going to be a lot of interest to watch the Jets with so many former Packers players, and then just the degenerate gambling in our management group was like, yeah, let's just take the risk.
Cook says he's heard enthusiastic responses from Packers fans, less so from Jets fans.
Clearly some Jets fans who have never been to the bar posting some fake reviews just saying we're no good. Been pretty funny.
To qualify, you got to be at Jack's 15 minutes before game time and stay for the entire game. Wyatt Barmore Pooley, WTMJ News.
Time now for news about your money in the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update. Right now, the Dow is up 41 to 34,893. The NASDAQ is up 78 to 14,021. The S&P is up 16 to 45.14. Get on track with investment and retirement planning. Visit nxwealth.com and click the Get Started button today. Sports, traffic, and weather next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 11:04.
Oak
Creek Lions Fest is back Friday through Labor Day, and you won't want to miss this year's lineup with three live music venues. Family fun, games, carnival rides, the Oak Creek Lions Big Money $8,000 cash raffle, helicopter rides, our craft beer tent, and the hottest and live local band favorites every day. Featuring great food with Friday's fish fry, Saturday's famous steak sandwiches and ribs, along with Sunday's ever-popular pork and beef sandwiches. And auto enthusiasts, don't miss Sunday's car show from 10 to 2. All three stages will be rocking with the hottest in local live music from DJ Red, Bella Kane, Arper's Bazaar, The Now, The Kingfish Band, Mount Olive, The Bluegrass All-Stars, and The Sensations, along with many other great bands. Don't miss the 2023 Oak Creek Lions Fest, 2 miles east of I-94, 3 blocks north of Ryan Road, and 9327 South Shepherd Avenue. Free admission, free parking. Friday through Labor Day, it's Oak Creek Lions Fest. Find out more at oakcreeklions.com, oakcreeklions.com.
Hi, this is Dr. Brad Schaefer. As a podiatrist, I can tell you no two people's feet are alike, which is why I recommend Dr. Scholl's Custom Fit Orthotic Inserts. They're customized for your feet, so you get a unique solution your feet really need, not just a one-size-fits-all insole. They're clinically proven to provide pain relief for achy feet, knees, lower back, plantar fasciitis, and heels. Take the Dr. Scholl's Custom Fit Orthotics Assessment in Walmart today, now in the foot care aisle.
Finding great candidates to hire can be like, well, trying to find a needle in a haystack, but not with ZipRecruiter. Its powerful technology actively finds and invites qualified candidates to apply to your job. So while other companies might deliver a lot of hay, ZipRecruiter finds you the needle in the haystack.
See why 4 out of 5 employers who post a job on ZipRecruiter get a quality candidate within the first day. Try ZipRecruiter for free at ZipRecruiter.com/free. That's ZipRecruiter.com/free.
Time for a WTMJ sports update. The Brewers fall to the Cubs last night. They try to take the series, though, this afternoon at Wrigley Field. Brewers and Cubs this afternoon. First pitch around 1:20 right here on WTMJ. Our pregame coverage starting around 12:40-ish. Again, right here on WTMJ. Time now for a WTMJ Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic report. Right now, 4145 northbound, really the only real slow spot. You're losing the right lane there, right around Capitol Drive, getting to Hampton Road there. So because of that, you're going to see some bottlenecking as you head north. You'll get through it just fine, but you are going to notice some brake lights in that stretch as you're dealing with that.
Traffic is sponsored by the famous Fox & Hounds restaurant near Holy Hill.
The famous Fox and Hounds and Mineshaft restaurants are hiring bartenders, servers, food runners, bussers, and hostesses. Make real cash. All ages welcome. Inquire today. Start next week. Great jobs.
The WTMJ 5-day forecast. Sunny and breezy. High of 71 today inland. Only 68 at the lake today. Tonight, clear and cool. A low of 48 inland. Thursday, sunny and pleasant. A high of 72. Friday, a high of 80. Saturday, a high of 90. Sunday, sunny, a high of 92 on Sunday. Right now in Milwaukee, it is 62 degrees. I'm Eric Bilstead, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 1107.
And now, news, opinions, Wisconsin. Everything you need to know in the Badger State and beyond. Now, here's your hosts, Sandy Max and Steve Scafidi.
And welcome, everybody. We've got an extended edition of the show today. We're going to spend a full hour, which we've had so much fun over the last few weeks, Sandy and I, doing Ask Us Anything. Got phone calls, got texts, tons of great questions already. You want to do serious first, Sandy, or fun?
Whatever you're in the mood for.
Okay, so let's do serious. Let's go on. Loyal listener, great fan of the show and the station. Bob from Waukesha leads us off. Hi, Bob.
Good morning, Steve and Sandy. How are you today?
Good.
How are you?
Something that has perplexed me for quite some time now, and perhaps you have an explanation. How in heaven's name, pun intended, do evangelicals and the law enforcement community justify supporting Donald Trump? Trump.
Fascinating question, Bob. I'll let you hang up and listen to the answer, but I always appreciate you taking the time to call. Look, I've talked about this before. I don't know if I've talked about it with the news show, but Americans have a choice. Republicans and Democrats, for the most part, independents not going to win the nomination or not going to win the presidency in the presidential election. We have a choice. And for whatever reason, evangelicals a big majority of law enforcement identifies as conservative in many cases, and for elections as a Republican. So that's built in, that's cooked into the numbers. Now, I can tell you that that's not absolute, and there's certainly people that are involved in faith, whether that's a pastor or member of a faith organization or church, temple, synagogue, whatever you have, who don't identify with what I just said. And that's America. And I think the mistake that some faith leaders make sometimes is saying, we vote as a bloc. Not true. That's why getting into the abortion debate, when you always say conservatives think this and liberals think that, trust me, I know people on both sides of that aisle who are pro-life and pro-choice. Not absolute. So that's the mistake we make. Now, the other question that I have, and hopefully I'm answering the question, when you think about law enforcement, typically in the past, I think this has been challenged by events like January 6th and others, conservatives and Republicans have been the law and order party. And for a lot of different reasons, some historic, Democrats were associated with riots, civil rights riots in the 60s and other eras. Don't know if that's true anymore, but that legacy, that history has certainly shaped those conversations. But I would caution people, and this is the encouraging part of my answer, that in the future, these hardened lines where all Republicans think this and all Democrats think this and conservatives, liberals, whatever term you want to use, those lines soften and we'll actually start using our gray matter again and make really smart choices for elected offices, whether it's your local mayor or your state rep or state senator, governor, Supreme Court, senator, U.S. senator, U.S. congressman or woman, and president. That's my hope. That's why I do the show. That's one of the main reasons I do the show is because I am so sick and tired. And I had friends beat me up on text today about the conversation about Hunter Biden. Like, you're so jaded on this. I'm not jaded. I'm tired of talking about nonsense. I refuse to talk about nonsense. And people who do that may make a lot of money, probably more than I do. Don't care about any of that. My mission statement for this show and my life is I'm not going to mess around with stupidity and things that make zero sense. Doesn't mean your opinion doesn't matter. It does. I will entertain almost any opinion on this show and always will. That's hopefully the best answer I can give on this question.
For me?
Yeah.
You just gestured at me. I was like, whoa. And now you. I do not know, because Bob's original question was how he is puzzled how evangelicals and police continue to support former President Donald Trump. I don't have a great answer for evangelicals. And again, talking about people in groups, but just based on Protestant Christians and believing in being born again and believing in more traditional teachings about authority and the Bible, maybe it's that seeming strength that Donald Trump embodies. So yeah, maybe there's that.
Charismatic figure.
And then as far as police, I agree with you, Steve, that I feel that the Republican Party in general calls themselves the Law and Order Party, but that is a huge conflict when it comes to January 6th in particular.
Yeah, that's the ugliness of that story.
Yeah, so I don't know where that wrestling and decision comes. But we're speaking in generalizations, and I wanted to explore Bob's question and my thoughts on that.
Yeah, it's good stuff. Good question. Good opening question, Bob. A fun one. Rick from Norway, Wisconsin, not the country. A fun question for you guys. Sandy, what is the furthest and farthest fun vacation that you have taken as an adult?
Furthest.
I'm trying to think now.
Probably, technically, Ireland. Or Ireland, I don't know which is a little further east. Ireland or Spain?
Spain.
But, okay.
Oh, maybe
Spain
not. No, maybe not.
I don't know if it's on my geography. Yeah.
Where's our world map?
But I haven't had a bad time in Europe.
No.
Not yet. I'm going to knock wood.
I'll be there in a little more than a week.
I just went to Spain for the first time in June to go to the Surferama Music Festival in Valencia and spent about 10 days also exploring Barcelona and Madrid. Highly recommend it. You can eat and drink your way through the tastes, whether it's Valencia orange juice. Isn't that funny? I always think of Florida, but yeah. Valencia orange juice, delicious.
Huh.
all sorts of small plates that you can enjoy in Spain. And then Ireland, I don't think anybody has a bad time in Ireland because the people are so friendly and welcoming and so much history and so much to see, whether it's the Cliffs of Moher or walking through villages. There's a lot to enjoy in Ireland. And like I said, I think England is going to be just west of both of Ireland and Spain. So I've had many a good time in England.
And he asked me about mine. Mine was probably, I wasn't in Istanbul, Turkey, but I was in Turkey and on the coast. And it was a smaller town. It was one of the ports of call on our last trip. So, I mean, that's about as far away as I've been. And they reminded us that when you're in Turkey, you're in Asia. It's like, that's the first time I had ever been in Asia before, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'll, as I said, I'll be in Tuscany, Italy, that region in about a little more than a week. So looking forward
to
that. Yes. And I'll have a full report. And for the first time ever, I'm going to bring back, not first time, I did it on my Alaska trip, some fun audio from the trip.
Yeah.
People that are on the trip, some of the fun we had. I think we're going to do a group trivia contest about WTMJ and give out some WTMJ prize packages while we're there and bring that back. And who knows what might happen? Shenanigans on the road as we travel. With
the
Fox
host,
World
host with the most.
Yeah, Rose Gray's coming with. So it's even more fun.
That'll be great.
All right, we'll take a break. Ask us anything. Great questions. We got a ton of them queued up. Steve from Oak Creek, my favorite city, and I love the name, has a question about Lambeau Field. We'll get to that one and more of your questions after this on WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this. This week on WTMJ.
The ABC News national correspondent Stephen Portnoy.
This will play out on television. It's very likely because of the openness of the Georgia laws.
The big names.
He is Major Garrett.
And just because you don't like the result doesn't mean you can endlessly and endlessly contest it.
The stories you're talking about.
The Wisconsin Ohana, which means the Wisconsin family, is who we're donating in the name, because it's everybody in Wisconsin in the community. So we're very grateful to be able to help.
News Radio WTMJ.
Hey, this is WTMJ, Steve's Committee for Educators Credit Union. I've told you the story. I was a new member last year, and I absolutely love working with educators. And I always say this, their online platform is one of the best I've ever seen when it comes to a financial institution. So check it out. When you open an Educators Credit Union checking account, you can say goodbye to surprise fees and hello to a whole lot of perks. Great experiences overall. Enjoy their rewards program, cash back, discounts, their really cool card customization. You can pick kind of the logo or the style of your card with their convenient digital services and nationwide network of, get this, over 60,000 fee-free ATMs. You can also access your account anytime, anywhere. Join Educators Credit Union today and take advantage of all the benefits that come with a checking account. I did. I love it. You will, too. Get started like I did at ECU.com. Federally insured by NCUA.
Henry Solfa from Penny Mustard brings out the philosophical side in me.
It has an old-school academia vibe.
The rolled arms and beautiful scallop back give it a distinguished look.
Plato said, wise men speak because they have something to say. Fools, because they have to say something.
Oh, I loved playing with Plato as a kid.
The Henry Sofa. American-made and exquisitely tailored with ultra-high-density cushions and hundreds of leather and fabric options. Starting at $24.52 at Penny Mustard.
Showrooms in Milwaukee and Chicago.
PennyMustard.com.
Hi there, it's Rose Gray from Fox World Travel. Let's explore the world together. Picture yourself traveling in style and luxury, embracing the beauty of the world and creating cherished memories with friends. We've curated one-of-a-kind immersive experiences just for you. Whether it's serene landscapes of Alaska, the enchanting history of Europe, the tropical paradise of Hawaii, the cultural wonders of Egypt, Japan, and Vietnam, or a breathtaking safari in South Africa, we've got it all. And that's not all. We offer diverse travel options from land to ocean and river journeys. Our award-winning Fox Group vacation experts have collaborated with the best tour and cruise companies, including Insight Vacations, Globus, Avalon Waterways, Uniworld, and Holland America, to craft these extraordinary itineraries exclusively available at Fox. Visit foxworldtravel.com to explore our incredible collection or call 866-GO-FOX-GO to speak with one of our knowledgeable travel advisors. The world is waiting for you, and we can't wait to embark on this thrilling adventure together. Let's explore the world together. Start your journey today.
It's WTMJ Now.
Ask us anything. Any question, fair game. Steve and Sandy Max, 855-616-1620. Steve from Oak Creek. That could be me. Hey, Steve.
Hello.
Yes.
My question is, will they ever put a retractable roof over Lambeau Field?
Let me ask you this little refinement of the question. Do you mean a temporary retractable roof or a you know, cover over the, or do you mean like permanent?
A permanent cover.
Yeah, I just to answer, thanks for the call, Steve. I think the answer is no, but I could see a scenario in the not too distant future where they actually, because this can be done. You can inflate a roof over almost any building now, and for a special use, put a dome over that thing, inflatable, kind of like what the Metrodome used to be. Remember they inflated that thing? I could see that happening for
especially a special event. If it tips in the chance for Green Bay to get a Super Bowl,
yeah.
If they negotiate that and say, hey. And then get a big sponsor on top of it. Sure.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Now, the challenge has always been, and they're even facing some of these challenges with the draft coming in a couple of years, hotel rooms. But here's the great thing about that. They're in the surrounding cities, Fox Valley, Milwaukee, even Chicago, because, I mean, let's be honest, what is that, a three-hour drive? And if you stay in the North Suburbs, it's 2.5. You can get there in plenty of time. The Super Bowl doesn't happen until nighttime, basically. So I think it's possible. Now, Mark Murphy said it's never going to happen. Well, he's going to be gone in a year or two. I think it is possible. So hopefully that answered your question. This one is from Jeff. Hi, Stephen Sandy. This one is mainly for Steve. Before the debates, you expressed an issue with Nikki Haley because of the possibility that she might pardon Trump. Where are you at now with her? Would you vote for her now? If she's running for president and gets the nomination, I would certainly vote for her. If she is aligned with former President Donald Trump, that's a no for me. And I've already talked about that extensively on the show. Pardoning the former president if he's convicted, that's also a non-starter with me. If you do the crime, you got to do the time. And for me, that's something that I'm absolute on. So that connection to Trump, I hope, doesn't happen. I've heard her comments on it. It's slightly irritating from a Haley perspective, someone who's actually written her name on a ballot. I don't like it. But, you know, time changes things, and the circumstances, the realities of what is happening to the former president right now could change all the dynamics of this race. And Jeff and Sandy and I had this conversation in the transition last week where we talked about, will Trump be the nominee? And Jeff agreed with me. I still don't think so, even though he's the leading candidate right now. I think something is going to happen, whether that's his choice or a decision made by juries or judges, or we're going to find out. What do we do during commercial breaks, Sandy Max?
You can see, usually, yes. On the YouTube channel.
We're talking?
Yeah, talking, planning our next break, our next talk segment, and a lot of catching up on emails and talk and texts in the moment, because as much as it's an interesting dynamic, because Steve and I want to talk to each other and give each other eye contact and have a flowing conversation, yet we always want to roll in your comments and experiences. So trying to keep one eye on the rolling, scrolling, talking text line, so that way we can weave you into the show as you've got clever comments and good points to make. So there's some of that catching up and going, oh, hey, did you see this comment? Did you see this text? So communication between the breaks, not tap dancing or nothing that you're missing out on.
No. And, you know, we're not swearing at each other.
Oh, my gosh.
There's no drama behind the scene, none of that stuff.
Coffee mugs.
No. Somebody asked me this question at golf last week. Like, how many texts do you get versus calls? We get a good number of calls. We get hundreds and hundreds of texts. And if you have a really crazy topic or, like, something that's just really firing, I've seen it almost spin where the thing is just moving. And I can't even keep up with it. Like, I try to read all of them.
Mm-hmm, me too.
There are times when it's not possible. We actually try to respond to a lot of them as well.
Yeah.
And we will, if we ask you what your name is, we're trying to put a name on the comments so we can have a better relationship. Kind of a fun thing we do as well. So there's a cool dynamic with the text line that didn't exist even, like, when I started here at WTMJ. It wasn't as big a deal as it is now. It's kind
Your time and your opinion are valuable to us. And if you're going to take the time to participate, sometimes even when it's just shouting a bumper sticker, it means you're listening and you either feel like you're not being heard or you want to be heard. So we read and try and respond when we can. So you're always welcome to join in on the phone. Use your thumbs or use your voice. The old National Bank talk and text line's always open. 855-616-1620.
This one from Stephen Cudahy. Have you and your lovely wife gotten used to watching TV using YouTube TV? And can you watch Brewers games on that service? You can't watch Brewers games unless they're nationally televised, because we do get the networks. But I've gotten used to it. And I'll nuts and bolts it for you. It's a little more involved than just having a like a traditional Spectrum or U-verse box where you punch in the channel number or just up and down. Mm-hmm. It's a little more involved than that. You go to a you know a favorites list and you select, and it takes a little more time. I would say 5 seconds versus 1 second. Mm-hmm. So that's a difference. I will tell you that the cost is tremendously lower. I have YouTube TV.
Okay.
I had UVerse service before that. I famously had a war on internet and cable service providers that I did on the show. I had a bit that I did. And we got to like 400 some days. But I was just disgusted with how they priced their products and how they lacked in customer service. So that for me was the line that said, I'm not doing this anymore. Mm-hmm. So my bill got as high. And I had basic cable, kind of, just the regular channels. Had HBO. And what I would call very average internet service from UVerse. And I've talked about this before. It's mm-hmm. not breaking news. Mm-hmm. $228 a month. My bill right now with a new internet service provider, which is T-Mobile, $30 a month. Better service, quicker. And YouTube TV, right now paying $54.99 a month. My math skills are not the best, but that's less than $100 for better service. Why wouldn't I change? And again, it's a little more involved than the older services. Yeah. But to me,
if it saves you $120 a month, it's worth it.
All right, one more from the phone lines here. Tom, welcome to the show from New Berlin. What's the question? Good morning.
Hi, Steve. My question is, why during the recent Republican debate were none of the candidates asked, what will you do to reduce inflation? What will you do to reduce gas prices? And actually, that's a fair question, but the answer is the president of the United States does not control the price of gas, inflation, or eggs. If he did, everything would be low, so he'd be popular.
Yeah, I mean, thanks for the call and the comment, Tom. Appreciate a call from New Berlin. Look, so much of that debate was nonsense again, and you know, getting their best shots in and arguing with each other and you know, Vivek Ramaswamy doing his big stage production, and he wanted to get that airtime, and apparently it's not worked out that he's gotten a big spike after that. So, you know, maybe next time. You're a young guy. Maybe you'll get back into the arena at some point. But the answer is, it's not sexy. Do you really want to hear? I would, because I'm a policy guy and an action guy. But most people don't want that in debate. They like the Trump theater. They like the Chris Christie theater of going at each other, fighting out loud, on camera, on TV. And I call this, and people get mad at me when I say this, including my wife, this is a byproduct of the Kardashian culture. Reality TV. Donald Trump came from that world. That's the interest level of most Americans now. That's how they consume. They want that anger. They want that angst. They want that tension. They want that nonsense. They're entertained by it. Politics as entertainment. Politics as a sports. I can't stand any of that stuff, but I get it pays, and people want to consume it, so that's what you get. So they're not going to talk seriously about things because they're not interested in that, and they think we aren't either.
And that's a really valid question, though, that he brought up. But it's complicated.
It is complicated.
It would be fabulous to just have a really big whiteboard set up at the back of the stage and have one of the candidates say, here, actually, here's the formula, and here are the six different factors that deal with inflation. Like Dave Spano could explain a whole lot of that to us, and he does it very clearly even without a whiteboard.
Yeah.
But it would be really challenging and interesting to have a candidate say, here, this really is a thoughtful question. I'm so glad you asked, moderator, and here's my answer.
Yeah.
And here are three people that I confer with to make sure that the economics are going in the correct direction.
Yeah.
Boy, wouldn't that be refreshing?
It would be. In a calm voice.
Wouldn't that be refreshing?
No theatrics. You know, I heard a local broadcaster talking about Keynesian economics the other day, and I'm thinking, oh my God, what are you doing? You're not an economics professor. What are you doing? You know, this
trying to be smart, I guess.
Everybody thinks they're an intellectual. I will tell you, over the air out loud, I know a little about a lot of things. I'm an expert on nothing. I have
tomatoes.
I have tomatoes, yes. Maybe. Even that. But someone has entrusted me with a microphone. They said, you know what? You have a point of view of the experience that matters. Therefore, you get to talk on the mic. Same with you. You have experience that matters. You have professionalism and a style that people like. That's what this is. So go back to your original question. Most people don't want that anymore. They want the noise. They want the theatrics. They want the nonsense. They want politics and sport. I say that's crazy, but I, as I said, holding up my phone again, I got great, great friends of mine blowing me up because I said something about politics that they didn't like. Are you serious, Jerry? Are you serious? Why? Because I disagreed with you? Listen better, be smarter. That's my lecture. I'm going to go to break. Lots more questions to get to. Sandy and Steve, ask us anything.
Sandy and Steve will be back after this. We heard that they have been pretty hot lately. It'd be a shame if they burned out.
Swung on, hit in the air, deep into center field. Back on it goes Taylor. Back onto the track, at the wall. It is gone! William Contreras!
The Brewers are at Wrigley for a three-game series against the Cubs. Our Brewers Radio Network game day coverage starts today at 12:45. We are the home of the Brewers. 620 WTMJ. This series is sponsored by Steinhoffel's Labor Day Sale.
Russ bought his first home in Wisconsin with a mortgage from Acunet when today's college freshmen were still in diapers. A few Friday mornings ago, Russ emailed saying he and his wife were ready to buy their forever home. And by 4 o'clock, we were all on a conference call with their real estate agent talking about what it would take to write a winning offer in today's inventory-starved market. And then it happened. They met their dream home face-to-face Saturday afternoon and wrote an offer $15,000 over asking, accompanied by an Acunet property-specific pre-approval letter that guaranteed they could make good on that offer without selling their existing home first and without requiring an appraisal. That's right, no appraisal required, which both the listing agent and seller loved. I can't promise your very first offer will be accepted like Russ and Julie's, but I will promise Acunet can help you and your agent craft the most attractive offer possible. Hey, don't settle for a flimsy, unimaginative bank pre-approval. Get started with your rock-solid, guaranteed pre-approval by clicking on the blue button today at accunet.com.
There's a race going on inside your body, and sometimes the bad guys, otherwise known as arthritis, get there first. That's when the joint pain kicks in.
Your healing process is just too slow and just can't catch up, and it needs just a little bit of help from QC Kinetics.
That's Dr. Daniel Zuckerman, a QC Kinetics medical director.
We all know that you can heal yourself. If you get a cut, it heals on its own. Your joints are no different. We can take the healing properties from your blood, concentrate them down, and put them in the spot that you need the help. It's amazing. Your body can heal itself.
At QC Kinetics, that's called regenerative medicine. No surgery or steroids, just lasting relief. The natural way.
The fact that we can treat them without surgery, but using their own body's natural healing process, without medications, without steroids, without surgery, it's just amazing.
Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
WTMJ Now.
All right. Ask Us Anything is the game that we're playing. Not a game, just a kind of a fun hour. I actually love this hour. I didn't used to because it was more political focused. I'll handle the political questions. I have no problem. Love doing it. And certainly that's going to be one of the big features of the next year of the show as we kind of layer in more and more intense coverage of this presidential election. Mm-hmm. RNC in Milwaukee, we have to cover it. So that's going to be part of that. I love the fun ones, too. And here's one for you, Sandy.
Okay.
Did you attend, this is from the 262, did you attend the Monster of Rock at Alpine Valley in the late 80s?
Oh, 1988. Those were epic. Those were before music festivals are so prevalent as they are now. I did not go. That would have been my college years, so I would have already moved back, because as I recall, that was would have been in the summertime at Alpine, and as I recall, it was like 3 days in a row. That would have been fun. And Van Halen, Metallica. Think about Metallica in 1988.
Woo!
Yeah. Man. Scorpions.
Oh, yeah.
It was like nine hours of music.
This is why stations exist and still play that music, because it's good. It's good music.
Yeah, but I mean, think of that party. Think of Alpine and think of that party. That's a lot. So
Alpine,
I hope
so many
you
great
went
memories
and had
Alpine.
Fun.
Yeah, I hope he did. I've had so many great memories at Alpine. So many great memories. I mean, just great. Super Tramp, like five times.
I saw the Stones, I think, September of 88.
That would have been a good
concert. September of 88 or 90? But in that range, it was the Steel Wheels tour. And they were at Alpine for several days in a row, and they had to have a smaller stage set up because Alpine's stage wasn't big enough, but they still had the huge inflatable women and the runway that would come out. So I got pretty dang close to Mick Jagger running out on a runway out over the audience. So that was cool. But it was, I went on the dreary day, which was like 55 and drizzly, and all of the cars in the parking lot, you know, just in mud.
Oh, yeah, yeah, because the parking lot's a mess.
And trying to get out, and car wheels were just spinning with big rooster tails of mud splattering on people. And the incline to get out.
Yeah, yeah.
You would just stand on that cement path, and you would slowly slide backwards because it was just mud and rain and wet. But it was rock and roll. Do you hear me complaining about it? It was part of the whole experience.
I've told this story before. One of the greatest concerts that I was ever at, and it's just like a weird one, was Simon and Garfunkel at Milwaukee County Stadium.
I thought you'd say at Alpine.
Sitting on the grass. It was unbelievable.
Interesting.
I mean, the sound of it was amazing.
I've always heard the legendary Pink Floyd show, but I've never heard Simon and Garfunkel at County Stadium.
With a really good group of friends, you know, in college. It was just like the best experience. Just love that.
Sounds mellow and happy.
And when they got along with each other. Now they apparently don't.
One of the other best shows I ever saw at Alpine Valley was the Sam and Dave tour. Sammy Hagar and David Lee Roth performing two different sets. Oh, that was a great night. That was a very fun night of Van Halen music.
I never saw Van Halen.
An odd night, but a fun night, because most of David Lee Roth's video presentation were slow motion videos of him and doing martial arts in different parts of cities. And his voice wasn't in great shape, but that's some great Van Halen music. And Sammy Hagar had a whole bunch of tequila gals and surfboards on stage. So his basically was a big commercial for for himself. But that was a fun night, a summer show. And some of the best cheeseburgers I've ever had in my entire life at Alpine Valley that night.
Really?
Yeah.
They're not known for their food.
No, but that was a great concession booth that night.
You weren't just hungry?
No. It was just one of those perfect summer nights of music. So yeah, Alpine has had some really good, really good music.
From the 920, this is more of a comment than a question. Steve, everyone thinks they know a little bit about everything. Most of us have access to the internet, which helps. I always, you know, I use the internet a lot. Trust me, I'm looking constantly for ideas and researching. But you got to be careful, folks. There's a lot of nonsense on there, and you know, certainly the affiliation of a site with a party, or certainly ideologies or organizations that are biased, is something that we have to kind of meander or navigate through. There's great resources out there. All I tell people when it comes to this sort of question about what you know, just get a variety of sources. You know, in my first days, I used to watch every night all the big networks, from CNN, MSNBC, Fox. I don't know if Newsmax was a big thing then or not. That got woven in just to see their different takes on the same stories. And I read a lot of online newspapers. I subscribed to the Wall Street Journal, Market Journal Sentinel, Chicago Paper, LA Times, New York Times for a while. And you get a sense of what the country is thinking about. But I realized early on that so much of these stories are actually, what's the right word? They're overcovered to the point where at some point there's so much information, I don't know how to process it. So you have to simplify it, dumb it down. We're talking about, let's go back to what we started the show with, Hunter Biden. What are the facts of the case? Clearly, he's a criminal because he is admitted he didn't pay his taxes and he bought a gun when he shouldn't have as a felon. Those are criminal acts. Now, there was a plea deal that's now gone awry and that's not going to happen. Mm-hmm. And there'll be a trial at some point and he'll have a sentence and he'll have to serve it. And we'll see how that shakes out. That's the real stuff. But the internet reality is, oh my God, Hunter Biden did this. Is Joe Biden involved? Is he a criminal? That's the internet reality. Those things, as we said earlier, have to be proven. So that's internet reality versus the reality that the world we should be living in, which is the things that are actually settled and proven and factual. That's the hard part. That's why everybody can't be a talk show host. Well, I take that back. Everybody can be a talk show host. Some people can make a lot of money, and they're really lousy at it. That's my personal take on talk radio. All right, one more from the text line before we go to break. Let's see here, James.
I've got a really simple one from Peter.
Yeah, take it.
Question for Steve and Sandy. Do you have or have you considered creating a little free library in your front yard? I don't have one yet, but I see more and more in my neighborhood with some comfy benches under shade trees. I have a large, diverse collection of surplus books, so I think I should join my neighbors in sharing written knowledge. I say yes. It's even a feature that we did on the arts page on Milwaukee PBS once. I adore a free public library.
Yeah, would I consider it? Sure.
I adore a public library, yes, as well. Course. A little free library, which is sometimes an adapted birdhouse, and it's got a little door, and you basically take one, leave one, or take one, or just give a whole bunch.
Yeah.
I really like that. I think it's charming, and it's another way to get to know your neighbors. And you know how it is. Book lovers have books, but don't always want them in your permanent collection. Yeah. So recycle those.
I think there's actually one in my neighborhood, because we walk around a lot, you know. Mm-hmm. There's one in my neighborhood not too
really
far away.
Get really creative with them, too, and paint them and make them super cute, or just have a regular one.
Yeah, when they're done nicely, it's kind of a cool little feature, kind of a cool little landscaping feature. So not opposed to the idea. All right, fire up those questions, 855-616-1620. A little show note, we have an expanded edition of the show today. So Jeff won't be here till tomorrow. We have an early Brewers game. Game 3 of the Cubs-Brewers series in Chicago, Wrigley Field, coming up about 12:45-ish. We'll get an official time on that in a little bit. But we'll take it right up to the start of pregame. And then, of course, the flagship station, the Milwaukee Brewers, will take it from there, the great announcers that we have working with our great team with the Milwaukee Brewers. And this year, first place, NL Central Milwaukee Brewers, with a current 4-game lead, which is impressive, and they can add to it today. All right. 855-616-1620. Questions for Ask Us Anything. We'll continue this to the top of the hour. Join us in the conversation, phone or text, after this.
More of WTMJ now, after this.
Have you Googled yourself lately? Are there negative posts from an ex-employee or from a former client? Maybe an outdated news article or sensitive personal information about your family? Search engines don't always get it right. But right or wrong, it's your reputation on the line. That's where Reputation Defender by Norton comes in. One of the most trusted names in online reputation repair. Reputation Defender has been fixing people's search results for over 15 years. Their cutting-edge approaches help you to wipe away unwanted information in your search results. They also promote the good stuff, so that it rises to the top, helping you put your best foot forward. Your good name is too valuable to leave to the whims of a Google algorithm. Take control with Reputation Defender. You can start by getting your free reputation report card at reputationdefender.com or call 800-401-6681 to speak to an expert. That's 800-401-6681.
Wealth-changing question. Has your advisor created a portfolio based only on your age and risk tolerance? That's simply not good enough. Your money deserves better, and so do you. At Creative Planning, our private wealth managers learn about you first, and then they create a customized plan and portfolio by partnering with our in-house money managers, accountants, and attorneys. Don't settle for a standard portfolio. Book your free meeting today at creativeplanning.com. Creative Planning, a richer way to wealth.
This is Matt Meitner, owner of Sit Means Sit Dog Training. Do you find yourself talking to your dog but feel like she's not listening to you?
Bella, sit!
Are you constantly repeating yourself but she's not following your directions?
Sit! Sit!
Frustrating, isn't it? At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we want to help you have a happy, confident, and obedient dog, and we also want to make the training process an enjoyable and worthwhile experience. Contact Sit Means Sit today to schedule a free consultation so we can create a customized training program so you are able to have the dog you want and deserve.
Sit Means Sit Dog Training. Sorry, we don't train husbands, wives, or kids.
It's WTMJ now.
It's your one-way ticket to midnight. Rocking it out on a hump day Wednesday here at WTMJ Now. Sandy and Steve, join us. We're doing a special one-hour edition of Ask Us Anything, a special edition of the show with an expanded, nearly 45-minute mega version of the program.
Supersize. We're inviting community leaders in. Next half hour?
Yeah.
Or just after noon, celebrating Oak Creek Lions Club.
Yeah.
This Labor Day weekend.
Big. It's a big deal in Oak Creek. You know this. I've been going to it since high school. It was the gathering place for all the high schoolers back in the day, because I went to Oak Creek High School. Everybody met at the...
walking distance, sure.
Yeah, from my house it was. Absolutely. Had so much fun. Stayed out of trouble for the most part. All right. Question for Steve on Ask Us Anything. You can join us. 855-616-1620, the old National Bank talk and text line. You stated Biden is not a criminal until he's proven to be one, and I would agree with that. Yet you continuously talk about and treat Trump as if he's a criminal regarding January 6th. Has nothing been proven in that respect. So my question to you is, do you feel you're a hypocrite? No. I've seen and heard the actions of the president. I have yet to see or hear any real evidence against the current president that indicates he's a criminal. I've heard a lot of allegations, and I support investigations to find out if he actually has, or his son has, used the presidential influence to gain traction, and if Joe Biden willingly cooperated with that, more than willing to hear that, but I haven't seen that yet. I was someone who was a critic of Trump before he ran for president. And I've seen and heard his actions during his presidency and since he lost in 2020. Which again, for the Republicans in the state of Wisconsin who are still arguing that fact 1,000+ days later, stop. Please stop. You're making yourself look like idiots. So my question, do I feel a hypocrite like a hypocrite? No, absolutely not. Trump, like Joe Biden, if it gets that far, deserve their day in court, or in the case of Trump, courts. Innocent until proven guilty. We'll find out. But if he's convicted, much different story. And again, if you support the efforts to look into Joe Biden, just on its face, wouldn't you also have to support the efforts to look into the conduct of former President Donald Trump? Seems like that would be a fair ask, right? In my opinion. Okay. Other than each other, this is a good question from Diane. Other than each other, who from 620 or Channel 4 would be the most fun to hang out with? I've hung out with a lot of people here. Bilstead's fun to hang out with. McCure's fun to hang out with. Who else have I hung out with? Not a lot of Channel... Well, Steve Shamraz from Channel 4. Spent some time with him. He's fun.
I'll tell you who was fun and will keep you laughing, and I like a lot. Debbie Lozaga.
Debbie's fun, yeah. She's the definition of fun.
Yes.
Yeah.
A bright spirit and loves to laugh and has a fun personality. You've heard it here. But yeah, that's one of my top picks.
Better question is, who's not fun? We're not going to answer that question. Let's see. Marty calling. I'm not sure about the question, Marty. What's the question? Calling from Milwaukee?
Good morning. Good morning, all. Yes, I was just wondering, Steve, it's been a while. I was just wondering if you had any plans to maybe bring back an interview that you had with Reverend Walter Lanier.
Absolutely.
American pastor,
yes.
Minister in Milwaukee. And I remember you had him on shortly after the George Floyd murder.
Mm-hmm.
And you had him on a couple weeks shortly after that, if not even sooner. And I'll tell you, it was one of the most interesting and in-depth conversations I think I've ever heard you have. It went on for a good 16, 17 minutes, and which is obviously a little unusual, but it was important at the time.
Absolutely.
And with all due respect, Steve, I don't know. You talk about being a fair guy and, all the incidents that you had to deal with as a mayor. But if I may be wrong. But notwithstanding politicians or sports celebrities or fellow employees, I do not believe that you've had a black man from Milwaukee on your show, and it's going on 3.5 years.
I'll stop you there, Marty, because, first of all, this is a show that welcomes all guests, and I've had the mayor of Milwaukee. I'm not going to sit here and argue about the race of our guests. We don't discriminate here. So, I mean, it's kind of a cheap shot. I will say this, the beginning part of that, Pastor Lanier, I just talked to him in the Third Street Market Hall a couple months ago.
Yeah.
And we talked about having him back on. Brilliant guy. Great local leader. His dad was famous, Bob Lanier. Absolutely always welcome. The interview that he's talking about, and this is a while ago, obviously.
2020, sure.
It was a fantastic interview. I remember that day, the post period of George Floyd, and he was eloquent and smart and everything you wanted a pastor to be, and he's always welcome back. But the cheap shot on race, I mean, come on. Well, you're better than that, Walter. I mean, that just no place for that, in my opinion. Maybe you disagree. And by the way, Jeff, on the text line, we just had Tory Lowe on.
I think Walter was being very specific, though. Didn't he say, like, it couldn't be coworkers or something? But so that's why I started to chuckle and go, Tory was just visiting.
Just in the studio at 9:30 this morning, so... I'll let it go and I'll let you speak, but cheap shot, in my opinion. Somebody asked a tomato question, completely unrelated to any of that. Why do you get the spots on your tomatoes? Why do you get cracks? It's uneven watering. So when we have heavy rains, don't still water. And you got to check, like if you have tomatoes in pots, a lot of times they get saturated. The quick way to tell if a tomato in a pot or any plant in a pot needs to be watered, nudge it. If it moves easily, it needs to be watered. If it doesn't move, it's got enough water in it.
Don't they still make watering worms?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
They were,
oh, yeah.
They were clay, yeah. And they would change color?
Yeah.
Let you know if you needed to water your plant of any type.
Let's see. You know, Steve, you know Biden was involved with Hunter's dealings. You sound ridiculous and very hypocritical. You can have your opinion. I'm reading your opinion. And I'll remind you that I read and acknowledge opinions that are different than mine. That's the difference about this station and this show. I'm going to say it again, just to baseline it for people. If Joe Biden has done something criminal, it needs to be investigated, prosecuted. And if he's convicted, we will certainly talk about it. Same thing with Donald Trump. Equal, fair and balanced, whatever term you want to use. I know that phrase has been corrupted. All right, one last chance, one last segment. Ask us anything. 855-616-1620. It's the old National Bank talk and text line. Sandy, Steve, WTMJ Now.
More of WTMJ Now after this.
Here's a penny for your thoughts. There's about 11,000 tire-related crashes every year.
Mostly due to driving around on underinflated, beat-up, worn-out tires with low tread.
A couple of clicks at richlawns.com will get you scheduled for a free tire tread test.
But if you're pressed for time, there's an old trick we use in the tire industry that'll tell you if you need tires.
And that's free, too.
My dad showed me, who learned it from his dad, who learned it from someone else way back in 1964.
Ah, yes, the old penny test.
Yep, just place a penny head first,
as in upside down,
into the groove of your tire. Now, if you can see the top of Lincoln's head, you're due for tires.
And hey, if the free penny test frazzles you, book an appointment at richlawns.com.
If your tires are good,
no harm, no foul, because it won't cost you a penny. Be safe, buckle up, and hey, always make sure you've got good tread on your tires. I'm Brett Machke with Richlawns. You're
due for service.
Such a refreshing change. Richlawns.
Don't miss out on the Labor Day sale at Ken Michaels Furniture. Our entire showroom of heirloom quality furniture is on sale. Enjoy an unprecedented 37% off Norwalk furniture, as well as 40% off Bradington Young and Hooker furniture. Create a sofa or chair as unique as you are with our thousands of customizable upholstery options. If you want spectacular discounts on their heirloom quality furniture, shop the Labor Day sale now at Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, and downtown Milwaukee. There's no doubt that a better night's sleep makes for better days, and a good quality mattress helps make it happen. When you buy your new Milwaukee mattress from Ken Michaels Furniture, you are assured of a mattress made individually for you out of the finest materials right from our own Milwaukee factory. We make every style, size, and firmness of mattress imaginable. And with our factory direct prices, you will save hundreds of dollars. Milwaukee mattresses from Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee. Where better days come from a great night's sleep.
I just learned Discover credit cards do something awesome. At the end of your first year, they automatically double all the cash back you've earned. That's right, everything you earned, doubled. See terms and check it out for yourself at discover.com/match.
With Social Security, the longer you wait, the more money you may get. Deciding when to start taking your Social Security benefits is one of the most important retirement decisions you'll make. Our team of advisors at Drake & Associates can show you the options and help you decide on the best decision for you and your situation. You spent decades paying in, optimize what comes out. Our experienced team can help you squeeze every penny out of your Social Security benefits. I'd love to get you our Retirement Ready Toolkit, which includes guides such as the Social Security Decision. To receive this complimentary toolkit, call or text SS to 414-409-9982. That's calling or texting SS to 414-409-9982.
Investment advisory services provided by Drake & Associates, LLC, an SEC-registered investment advisor. Insurance products are offered through a separate company, Loft Financial Advisory Group, LLC, a Wisconsin insurance agency. Clients are under no obligation to purchase any recommended insurance products.
WTMJ Now.
All right, last segment of Ask Us Anything before we get to the top of the hour news here on WTMJ. Don't forget, extended edition of WTMJ Now today. Early Brewers game, Cubs Brewers from Wrigley Field on the flagship of the Milwaukee Brewers, WTMJ. Let's see.
Paula's question is entertaining.
Which one is that?
Well, you're in Italy.
Yes.
Whooping it up with WTMJ fans.
Yes.
Who in the world is going to be in your chair?
I'll let you answer that one.
Well, because you didn't have to plan.
Yeah.
I will give you a sneak peek that it will be a variety of movers and shakers and storytellers, some that you will recognize from television, some that you will recognize from around the city at major events. So that's your hint. But people that maybe you haven't heard from in a little while and that you'll be interested to hear fresh perspectives and what projects they're working on.
Thought leaders.
That's a good phrase that you like. Yeah. Yeah.
Different one every day.
Yes.
No repeats.
Correct.
Wow.
You got a big seat to fill.
That's a big schedule just to get all that. How long did that take?
I'm a woman who's focused.
Wow.
That's
impressive.
Well, thank you. Hopefully you'll be impressed when we reveal who the guest co-host will be. But I take it very seriously because it's a great opportunity to continue to tell stories of Wisconsin and who's here and sharing those stories and opinions.
I love it. Now I'm curious.
Oh, good.
Although I kind of know some of the names.
Good. But
I'm thrilled that you got some of these names. So
good.
Good job, you.
I'm flattered that they want to come hang out.
Yes. And must listen radio, 9 to noon, from the 8th through the 18th.
Well, we just say all of September and for the rest of the year.
Paula,
thanks for being curious. And we take it seriously. I don't want to lose any momentum while you're gone. And there's still a lot of topics to talk about. Fun and important. So,
thanks for that. Great question, by the way.
Yeah.
Was it Paula?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, great question, Paula. From the 414, I got a million versions of this. I'm just going to quickly get to it. People don't trust that the Department of Justice for either party is going to hold a person of their own party accountable. You imply that justice will prevail. In today's environment, how can you assume that? It doesn't happen with legit criminals in major cities. Why do you think the feds are different? Because I answered the texter, what's the alternative here? If you don't trust anybody, it's chaotic, and we are in a nightmare scenario where no institution can be trusted, no government at any level can be trusted, no elected official, and then, frankly, we don't trust each other. So let's think about this stuff for a second. Now, the texter said, I love you, Steve, like a brother. I appreciate that. And hopefully I answered your question. What's the alternative? Kangaroo courts, guys buying tech vests on the internet and walking around like tough guys in the community, they're going to be the justice system? No, thank you. All right. Quick phone call. Mark from Cedar Grove.
Hello. How are you, Steve?
I'm good. Very enthusiastic greeting.
Thank you for letting me on. I just wanted to bring some clarity to some years of presidency and some years of nursing. So the years that Joe Biden has been in, they should put a cape on him as a Superman because he saved us in the pandemic. Not only that, but the CDC was in on it, and so were the nurses. A lot of people are forgetting about that.
So you are a Biden supporter, Mark?
I have become one, yes.
All right, so quickly, because I only have 30 seconds, what is the question you want to ask us?
Well, I just wanted to bring that forth that people need to really think about Biden as more of a Superman and a president because he has helped us through the pandemic, and so have the nurses. It's really not a question. I just wanted to bring some clarity because I think it needs to be said.
All right, Mark, we gave you a little bit of a forum there. Not really a question, but he's passionate about it, so we brought him on real quick. I'm not going to bring Jim on because we're running out of time. The question is, and thanks for taking the time to call, Jim. If I have tickets to a division, or we have tickets to a division playoff game for the Brewers on a Sunday, or tickets for a Packer game, which do you choose? I would choose the Packers game.
I go Brewers.
Yeah, see, everybody's different. Those are really good choices, though.
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah. Brilliant question, Jim from Fond du Lac. I love the choice. And, currently Brewers, 4-game lead. Packers, who knows what the Packers are going to be? Nobody does. We have 8 billion talking heads in this country about, who's good, who's not good. Jordan Love, yes. We'll find out.
Mm-hmm.
We start playing in about, 10 days or so. We'll all figure it out. Fantastic addition this week of Ask Us Anything. Now, we're not done, Sandy. We have a bonus half hour plus. And we have special guests coming and talk about this great festival that I know and love in the city of Oak Creek. Great partners of WTMJ as well. You hear their ads running all over our station. They will join us after the news, which is next right here on WTMJ. Great questions.
More of WTMJ now after this.
Be our eyes on the road. See something out there that I should know about?
Hi, there is an accident on I-43 northbound.
Call me, Debbie Lozaga, at the HallMazda.com traffic tip line at 414-238-9329.
Hi, Debbie, it's Michael. Just drove through the area of 894 West. There's debris in the roadway.
The drive affects you. Why not be part of it?
I'm sitting here in I-43 north of Silver Spring at the parking lot.
Give me a call, 414-238-9329.
Is there anything sweeter than the crisp sound of a driver when it connects purely with the ball? Many golfers evaluate the quality of their shot by the sound it makes. You may feel the same about your financial plan. Something doesn't seem, look, or sound right. Think of Annex Wealth Management as financial swing doctors. We'll give you the truly objective analysis that comes from a fee-only fiduciary with no products to push or commissions to chase. If you need help, talk to our pros. Get started at AnnexWealth.com.
As an emergency medical technician, I hope motorists can remember these four life-saving words. Buckle up, phones down. It means wear a seatbelt. Every seat, every trip. And when driving, stay focused on the road ahead. Protect yourself, spare your family, and emergency responders from needless trauma.
Do your part to help us move towards zero deaths on Wisconsin roads. A safety message, sponsored by the U.S. and Wisconsin DOTs.
At Staples, school savings are always in session, from art supplies and essentials to the latest tech. In stock and priced low. School on, save on at your local Staples store.
With inflation affecting so many families, the super affordable Mein Chef restaurant in Hartford is better than ever. WTMJ's John Mercure here. My wife Michelle and I love the Mein Chef. The breakfasts are big and $8.99 or less. Every Wednesday, build your own burger or chicken sandwich with a pile of hot fries for only $9.99. The codfish fries, all you can eat, and also $9.99. That's lunch or dinner for under $10. Kids menu starts every day at $3.99. Mein Chef desserts are all buy one, get one free. I love the chocolate cake, maybe a little ice cream. Every Thursday, buy one pizza, get one free. Order pizza for your loyal employees today and pick up your hot pizza tomorrow. They will love it. Happy hour today is from 2 to 5 with half-price drinks, half-price beers, half-price cocktails. The super affordable Mein Chef restaurant on Main Street in beautiful downtown Hartford and off the interstate in Oshkosh. No reservations needed. Just walk on in. MeinChefRestaurant.com.
Russ bought his first home in Wisconsin with a mortgage from Acunet when today's college freshmen were still in diapers. A few Friday mornings ago, Russ emailed saying he and his wife were ready to buy their forever home. And by 4 o'clock, we were all on a conference call with their real estate agent talking about what it would take to write a winning offer in today's inventory-starved market. And then it happened. They met their dream home face-to-face Saturday afternoon and wrote an offer $15,000 over asking, accompanied by an Acunet property-specific pre-approval letter that guaranteed they could make good on that offer without selling their existing home first and without requiring an appraisal. That's right, no appraisal required, which both the listing agent and seller loved. I can't promise your very first offer will be accepted like Russ and Julie's, but I will promise Acunet can help you and your agent craft the most attractive offer possible. Hey, don't settle for a flimsy, unimaginative bank pre-approval. Get started with your rock-solid, guaranteed pre-approval by clicking on the blue button today at accunet.com.
The place you want to go, Lynch McGuanago.
Nobody sells for less than Lynch.
WTMJ, W277-CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station. Ah, nothing like a late summer dust up with an old foe.
On the ground, left side to play.
The I-94 rivalry heats up as the Brewers travel south for a clash with the Cubs.
The Cubs get their hearts broken again.
The Brewers-Cubs series is sponsored by Steinhoffel's Labor Day Sale. Our Brewers-Cubs coverage gets underway beginning at 12:45. We are your home of the Brewers. 620 WTMJ, Milwaukee.
It's 12:03 and 64 degrees. Your storm team forecast, mostly sunny today, a bit on the breezy side, and pretty cool, too. 71 degrees, your high temperature away from Lake Michigan. Closer by the lake, 68 for your high. Tonight, clear and cool. Low down to 56 lakeshore, 48 inland. And from the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Vince Vetrano. Losing steam, but still packing a punch. Idalia now a Category 1 storm, largely over Georgia right now, sights set on the Carolinas. After making landfall where the Florida Peninsula meets the Panhandle, ABC's Jim Ryan is in Tampa. Winds in that area exceeded 120 miles an hour.
That makes Idalia a powerful Category 3 storm, the strongest to hit the Big Bend region since 1896.
I went through the storm of 1993, storm of the century.
That man lives in Keaton Beach, Florida, near the point of Idalia's landfall. He evacuated and headed inland, and now...
I don't know if I'm going to have a house to go home to.
Idalia is blamed for at least one fatality. The driver of a pickup truck in Pasco County lost control during the storm, crashed into a tree, and was killed instantly. Jim Ryan, ABC News, Tampa.
Florida Governor Ron DeSantis hosting a news conference this hour. Rescue workers busy due to major storm surge. In Cedar Key, a guy who lives there saying he stayed on the island, is helping best he can, since the only way off that island now has been damaged.
The very minute we can put our boats in the water, we'll get to them before any help can make it across the bridge from the mainland. So we're after it. We're going to take good care of them.
Meanwhile, here at home, We Energies has trucks on standby in case their crews are called in to help in Florida with recovery efforts. The Vice President of Field Operations, Dave Megna, telling TMJ4 News how many crew members are sent down will first be determined by what we would still need here in Wisconsin.
Typically, we send our contractors first, and then we look at if they need more resources, we'll look at internal crews. But it's all based on what's happening on our system, the weather. We don't want to deplete our resources so that we can't restore customers if something happens here.
Multiple flights from Milwaukee Mitchell International to both Tampa and Orlando canceled this morning. Again, Idalia now a Category 1 storm moving over Georgia and the Carolinas. Tonight's full moon will be the brightest of the year. NASA says the supermoon occurs when the moon's orbit is closest to Earth at the same time that the moon is full. 3 to 4 supermoons occur each year, and they always appear consecutively. Tonight's supermoon, also a blue moon, a name given when a full moon appears twice in 1 month. Time for news about your money, WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. Dow Jones Industrial Average up about 74 points so far on the day at 34,926. The S&P 500 at 4518, that's up 21 points. And the NASDAQ up as well. NASDAQ is up about 86 points to 14,029. Get on track with investment and retirement planning. Visit AnnexWealth.com. Click on the Get Started button today. Sports, traffic, weather are next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 1206.
This report sponsored by Mr. Holland's Heating and Air Conditioning. Visit MrHollandsHeatingAndAir.com.
If Mr. Holland's Home Services was an ice cream shop, our featured flavors would be Caramel Apple Air Conditioner, Hot Fudge Furnace, Double Dutch Ducks, and the always popular Cookies and Cream Clean Air. Okay, so we're not in the ice cream business. Yet. But if you have a craving for comfort, Mr. Holland's serves up a sure bet. Enjoy a sweet treat of Arctic air from a new factory fresh AC, or face the winter freeze with a brand new fiery furnace, professionally installed by Mr. Holland's talented techs. And you won't have to spend a lot of money, because we offer monthly payments as low as $99 a month. Sprinkle in some delectable duct cleaning, and you've got the makings for a triple scoop of comfort in a cone all year long. Call 866-992-1717 or visit MrHollandsHomeServices.com. If you're looking for total home comfort with a cherry on top, we can help.
I know you have a great dog, right? But you know there's room for improvement. At Sit Means Sit Dog Training, we can help. Our attention-based training system uses modern technology to help you better communicate with your dog, even in high distraction. When you schedule a free consultation with us, you will have the opportunity to see our training in action and meet for yourself our happy dogs off-leash and under control. Contact Sit Means Sit today at 262-361-3641 or find us on the web at sitmeanssitwaukesha.com to schedule your free consultation so you can have a happy, confident, and obedient dog.
Hi, it's Rose Gray from Fox World Travel inviting you on an unforgettable 2024 adventure. Explore Alaska, Europe, Hawaii, Japan, Egypt, Vietnam, and South Africa by land or river exclusively with Fox World Travel. Our award-winning experts crafted extraordinary itineraries with Insight Vacations, Globus, Avalon Waterways, Uniworld, and Holland America. Follow your wanderlust. Visit foxworldtravel.com or call 866-GO-FOX-GO to start your journey. Let's explore the world together.
Time for WTMJ's sports update. The Brewers this afternoon, now once again 12 games from Free Hamburgers.
We're all fascinated by free. I mean, it's, you say free, I mean, that's going to get the best marketing slogan ever.
Sure is. Brewers manager Craig Counsell on Wisconsin's Morning News Tuesday. Best marketing ever because George Webb got all the hype and pub and they didn't even have to pay out. Corbin Burns for the Crew, 7 strong innings. Only one run, that was in the first, and that was that. Cubs win 1-0, snap the Brewers' streak at 9 games.
9 times.
1:10 first pitch today from Wrigley Field, 12:45 broadcast time on your home of the Brewers, WTMJ. And the Packers may be interested in bringing on a former Badger at running back, ESPN quoting sources that indicate the Packers were talking with the Indianapolis Colts about a trade for Taylor. Jonathan Taylor wants out of Indy. The Packers are pretty well stacked at running back, and Taylor is now on the physically unable to perform list, meaning he has to miss at least the first 4 weeks of the season. But ESPN says there is still, quote, trade interest. NFL trade deadline is October 31st. Take a look at your roads and the Johnson & Sons paving time saver traffic. Very slow drive northbound 41 between Capitol and Silver Spring. Extra time needed to get through there on your way out to Menomonee Falls, that area. Northbound traffic also slow on I-43 north of the city. On the brakes from North Avenue up to Capitol Drive.
Traffic is sponsored by Hall Mazda Milwaukee. Visit hallmazdamilwaukee.com.
If you see something we should know about, call the WTMJ Hall Mazda Traffic Tip Line, 414-238-9329. We discover the road at Hall Mazda during Mazda's Season of Discovery.
WTMJ 5-day forecast. Early clouds, then mostly sunny and breezy. High of 68 at the lake, 71 degrees inland. Clear and cool tonight. Inland temperature could dip below 50 degrees. Thursday, sunny and pleasant. High of 72. Then we start warming it up. Mostly sunny on Friday with a high of 80. Saturday's high 90 degrees under partly cloudy skies. And then mostly sunny on Sunday. High of 92. Right now in Madison, just 63 degrees. Green Bay at 62. Waukesha, 64. And the same here in Milwaukee, 64 degrees. I'm Vince Vetrano, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time, 1210.
It's WTMJ Now. News, opinions, Wisconsin. Everything you need to know in the Badger State and beyond. Now, here's your hosts, Sandy Max and Steve Scafidi.
That is us, a special bonus edition of WTMJ Now. Sandy Max and Steve and two special guests in studio. Now, anybody that lives in the Oak Creek area knows about the famous Labor Day Lions Fest. It's like, I went to high school in Oak Creek, and that was like, you all went to that thing after you, whatever you're doing in the summer in Oak Creek and getting ready for the school year. So, joining us in studio, former president of the Oak Creek Lions Club, Scott Koenig.
Hello.
All-around handyman as well. I know that because I know you personally. And the big guy, presidents, festival co-chair. What other titles have they hung on you at the Oak Creek Lions Club, Bruce Hubbard?
That's about it. Just another
Chief talker.
Right, there you go.
Yeah, every meeting I've been at, you've been yakking it away up at the podium. So,
you bet.
So let's talk about it. This is a big festival in Oak Creek, but it's a big festival for the area as well. Labor Day Fest. You guys make a ton of money, and the cool thing, and we'll get to some of this, that money's doled out to organizations, individuals, and really important causes in our community. So let's start with the basics. President, co-chair. What are we talking about? What's involved? What will people expect when they go out there?
Well, there's 4 days of music, fun, and food, and of course, beer. Can't have a festival without beer.
And you have a lot of it.
Yes, we have 33 bands booked over the weekend. Four days.
33 bands.
Yes, sir.
Who's coordinating all that activity?
That would be myself, Lion Scott, and Lion Tim Summers, and Lion Mike Hobbs.
Let me drop some names on us because we all kind of know the local bands, but you got some of the best ones.
Bella Kane Friday night.
Mount Olive, I know.
Mount Olive, we've got them on Sunday night. We've got a lot of blues bands, Blues Disciples, Third Coast Blues Collective going on in our craft beer tent.
You guys have really fancied it up. Craft beer tent now.
Craft beer. We're going to try to get pizzas in there this year so you can get a
what
craft
do you mean,
beer.
Pizzas? You're going to make pizzas
we're
or you're going to bring
make
them in?
Pizzas there. And that's what we're trying to do new this year, one of the features that we've added. But so that Butcher Block sponsored craft beer tent started 2 years ago, and we've slowly built it up. We've got music in there all day long now too, plus the craft beers, and we're trying to add the pizzas this year also. But like Lion Bruce said, 33 bands in three different places, a main stage, an inside stage, and then our outside craft beer tent. Every genre that you can imagine, we've got rock, old rock, new rock, country western, a lot of blues.
Country and western.
That's what I was going to say.
Country and western. Yeah, I stand corrected.
Yeah.
Polkas. Still very popular. We get some of the big polka names in the area.
That'll be Friday. We have Senior Day. That starts at 11 a.m.
Why are you looking at me when you say that?
Well, you're invited.
I'm just giving you three.
Saturday. I'm there with you, pal.
Yeah, I know you are. I think you're older than me, actually.
Saturday, right. We have Family Day also with children's area inside. We
the rides thing, right? The band or whatever you call it? The
wristbands.
Wristbands. What? Give me some prices.
Wristbands, I believe it's around like $25 for one day.
And unlimited rides.
Yeah.
It's a great deal. I see families out there just going crazy on this.
Yeah, there's a number of different places in the area, including the Oak Creek Community Center, where you can get these wristbands.
You can find me on the Tilt-A-Whirl or on the Scrambler.
That makes me want to hurl.
The Tilt-A-Whirl?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You're not doing it right then.
Yeah, I know.
You got to lean.
Makes me dizzy.
Yeah.
Bumper cars. Get the spin going, yeah. Yep. And will you have games? Because I don't know what the name of the game is where you get the paint stick with a number, but I've won a block of cheese.
Yes.
I'm a big fan.
Tell that is people about this stuff.
Yeah,
you got meat thing, you got the cheese thing.
We've got two tents, two wheels spinning continuously. And for a dollar, you get a chance to win some beer, a one-pound block of cheese, a six-pack of soda, or a pound and a half Clemens sausage. So then we bump it up every once in a while to like a 15-pound bottom round roast. We've got ribs, tenderloins, hams.
Yeah. But it's interactive. It's fun because you've got your paint stick with the number and you can crack it on the ledge.
Yeah, you're knocking it around.
There.
Yeah. They're yelling at you. I call this the take all my money raffles.
Right.
Because whatever I have in my wallet is consumed by these raffles. My wife and Kathy insists on it.
So we'll do meat raffles in one. And then that'll kind of settle down, and then we'll move over to the other tent, and we'll get some big meat raffles going in there. And we vary, you know, the type of meat that we put out there. So, and the people are like three deep waiting for that big meat. And that goes all weekend long. We do that nonstop.
It's a fun level of excitement. And when we talk about the Lions Club, I often think of vision and the charitable work that goes, like, collecting eyeglasses. What are some of the organizations that will benefit from the raffle and the fun that's happening this weekend?
Some of the things that Lions are for are our vision, leader dog, childhood cancer, diabetes, you know, on that line of things. So
I can remember you helped me on Best Buddies.
Helped
me on a turkey thing that we did for Hunger Task Force.
Yes.
They have stepped up for me in many, many ways and continue to do that. And they are just a tremendous organization. Let me ask you like a logistical question. I know you've been looking for volunteers. Is that still a need out there? Because
we still have some openings.
Yeah, so if everybody wants to just have fun and help, how can they find out and who can they talk to?
OakCreekLions.com. We have a lot of information on that website that'll tell you who to contact. It gives you descriptions of the different areas where you're going to work and the like basic job description, basically. So you can find out what you can do, what you want to do, what you're comfortable with, hours. And then call somebody and sign up. They're 4 to 5 hour shifts, so it's not a lot.
It's a fun festival. We'll take a break. We're joined by Scott Canning and Bruce Hubbard from the Oak Creek Lions Club. Big Labor Day Festival. You've heard their ads running on WTMJ. Great partner of ours as well. We'll take a break. Want to ask you a couple questions about the events and certainly about the organization, because I follow you guys and I'm at a lot of your events. And I see you've been adding members. I want you to kind of dig into why you think that is, why it is so popular now to be an Oak Creek Lion or a Lions Club member in general. You guys are blowing up as far as new members. So I want you to explain that to our audience. We'll do that after the break on WTMJ Now.
Sandy and Steve will be back after this. WTMJ's John Mercier here. Join me as we count down to the RNC in Milwaukee. We'll talk to the biggest names across the political landscape. Ronna McDaniel, she is the chair of the Republican National Committee.
The American public really wants to see what Republicans are putting forward and what our plan is to turn the tide.
Full podcast available on WTMJ.com or text RNC to the Old National Bank Talk and Text Line, 855-616-1620, and get a link sent directly to you. It's the countdown to the RNC podcast, only here on WTMJ.
Now, about your house. Eric Brown is the president of Siding Unlimited, your contractor for new windows, roofing, siding, decks, and a whole lot more. He knows about your house. So what do you know, Eric?
Imagine watching a TV show and turning around and acting as if you can do the same. You see how easy it is and you think, yep, I can do that in a half hour too. However, reality TV certainly isn't reality, and do-it-yourselfers, with all due respect, are not professionals. Leave remodeling projects to the pros. We hear the stories and there just isn't much we can do. Homeowners deciding to take on projects they have no business doing. Although the excitement is real, so is the final product. If your imagination says yes, understand that if the outcome results in a big no, you've set the value of your home back quite a bit. Imagine buying a house from a do-it-yourselfer. Now imagine selling your home after you did it yourself. The do-it-yourselfer is going to save money, right? So the first step is rushing to the store and buying the expensive tools that after one project are going to sit in your garage. So you really didn't save any money. Then you research and purchase the product. Typically, homeowner product purchases don't have the same warranties, and not the best products are accessible through the local outlets. So you're going to do it yourself with products that are less than desirable. Tools you'll never use again? Check. Products that are okay but not great? Check. Now the do-it-yourselfer starts working. Set up, prep work, and go. Because planning is all in your head, right? You're ready for your first cut? Uh-oh, a trip to the ER. Meanwhile, your wife is staring at you, shaking her head. Leave the reality TV for entertainment, leave the projects to the pros, and leave your free time to your family. Call Siding Unlimited.
Eric and his crews at Siding Unlimited are your home's go-to contractor here. Take your next step and check them out at SidingUnlimited.com. Siding Unlimited, siding and a whole lot more.
WTMJ Now.
Talking with the guys from the Oak Creek Lions Club, big Lions Fest, Labor Day Festival, Legion Grounds, Shepherd Avenue, kind of the center of the city between Ryan and Hutes.
It is, absolutely.
Yeah, right in the middle, easy to get to, lots of parking.
Mm-hmm. Plenty of parking.
Yep. What'd you say,
free parking.
Yeah, free parking. 33 bands.
Yes. 33 bands over the weekend.
Yep. Beer never runs out. Has it ever run out at a festival?
Never.
Nope.
I see the trucks come in, so I know you guys are constantly... they constantly replenish the supply. That's what we're talking about with this, with the beer.
This is 64th annual. Yeah. So I can just say, on our watch, we have never run out of beer.
You don't know what the previous guys did. Don't. They may have run out of beer. And you got the special beer tent now,
the craft beer.
Craft beer. We've got pizza in there. Just a couple of the other interesting things about this year's festival that maybe that were... the helicopter rides. Tell me about
helicopter ride, yep. They'll be back again this year. They'll be there all 4 days, starting Friday afternoon. So they'll give you a nice ride, hopefully over the lake, depending on how the planes are landing at Mitchell this year.
How much do you guys sweat this? I know you do this.
Huge.
The weather forecast. Yeah, that's the whole thing, right? Because heaven forbid we'd have like all rain forecast. You guys have been pretty lucky with the weather.
We have. Yeah. Last few years, we've had 1 year where we had a little bit of rain.
Yeah.
My outlook on it is we get all the work done. And I don't even look at the weather because there's not a thing you can do about it. So
true.
It's just get the
true
job done and hope for the best. And
forecast,
we've been lucky.
Forecast is summer. It's still sunshine. Highs near 80 Friday, 89 Saturday, 93 Sunday, 91 Monday. But that's just summertime.
Yep.
And you catch a breeze on one of the carnival rides or enjoy a cold beverage under the shade in one of the stages. Like, it's what we wait for. And this is squeezing out that last vibe of summer. Plus pull tabs, right?
Plus pull
Who
tabs.
Who doesn't love pull tabs?
We have a cash raffle.
Yeah,
cash,
our big cash raffle.
Cash raffle. Is it $8,000?
We're giving away $8,000.
When does that happen?
$5,000 for the first prize winner. The winner will get picked late Monday afternoon, right before we close, about 6 o'clock.
And where can people buy tickets for that?
Information booth on the grounds. You can get tickets all weekend long or until we run out, and that has happened. We only print 3,000 tickets, so get down there, get your tickets, get them soon. Buy many, buy them often.
All right, so I've emceed events. I've attended your events. I've been in the festival since I was in high school, as I said. And I've noticed, because I see a lot of your notices, a lot of your emails, a lot of your contact that you put out, that you guys are adding members like crazy.
Yeah.
I kind of know why that is, but I want you to say, why is it so much fun to do hard work for great causes? People seem to be signing up like crazy for you guys.
Yeah, we are the Oak Creek Lions are the largest Lions Club in Wisconsin right now.
I didn't actually know that.
Yeah, we're 143 members, and next dinner meeting mid-September, we'll be adding six more. So people join to give back to the community. It gives you a sense of goodness and, you know, to give back in the place you've grown up in. That's why I did it.
I love that story, because that's not everybody else's story. I've spoken in front of groups where they're losing members. They're declining. You know, some groups that I've been a part of have closed shop, and they can't get people to sign up. And the magic of the Lions is, one, great causes, and we talked a little bit about that. But just the fun you have. I've been to the meetings. It's an absolutely incredible event, and you take that fun to the Lions Fest. I usually pick a couple days. I'm not there every day. But it is such a unique piece of Wisconsin life, right? It's kind of at the end of the summer. Well, it is the end of the summer, Labor Day for a lot of people. And it's a celebration of all the things we love doing. You talked about, say, the music. It's incredible.
The music is fun. I love polka mass, and I love that you work in the polka bands early in the day. That warms my heart. I've seen many great bands, and it's just that wonderful, friendly vibe. And no matter where you live, you don't have to live in Oak Creek to go to the Oak Creek Lions Fest. I'm pretty sure you'll bump into somebody that you know that you haven't seen in a while. And it's that gathering of people and just a really happy vibe.
Well, you don't know this, but certain classes have like mini reunions at the festival.
Oh, that's smart.
Like I will get emails saying, hey, any class of 76 people going to show up? And sometimes I do, sometimes I don't.
Yeah, we've had a Delphi reunion there too.
That's right.
Times.
Yeah.
When the Delphi plant was still up and running, there was like 5,000 people that worked at Delphi and that went away. And so they've had a few reunions.
Yeah, absolutely.
But to your point, we try to put the fun into it first. We do a lot of fun events, and there is a lot of work involved, but we've been so lucky to get some really great people with different skill sets, lots of energy. Mm-hmm. But we're one of the few clubs that have been doing that. Other clubs come to us and say, you know, how are you guys doing this? And it hasn't been like one thing you can put your finger on. It's just things that have been building the last few years with the right people. It's like putting a Super Bowl team together, right?
Yeah.
You pull in a bunch of different players and hope the chemistry and stuff is there. And we've had that for quite a long time, and we just keep building off of it.
I know both of you guys. We've obviously done a lot of stuff together. Bruce and Scott joining us in the studio from the Oak Creek Lions Club. It's guys like Jerry Ashbaugh, the unofficial mayor of Oak Creek, who's been a member for like how many years? 60 years or something?
Yeah, 40 some years.
Yeah, I mean, it's incredible.
Very long time.
These are everyday members of the community who are just touching so many lives. Mm-hmm. I always have you in every year because I love the work that you guys do and the fact that you're willing to do all that hard work and then share all the profits that you make from these events with the community. Keep up the great work. Fantastic job. I always say, however I can help you, I have committed to joining the Oak Creek Lions once I'm done on the radio. That is a commitment that I made out loud. And I will honor that commitment.
Very good. Sponsor you.
I can't
They're
wait to
standing
the party.
In line to sponsor you.
Yeah, I know. I can't wait to the party for that. That's
you just got one more volunteer gentleman from the old National Bank talk and text line, 855-616-1620. Someone from Forum 4 wrote, texted in, well, this should be fun. I just signed up to serve street corn from 2 till 6.
Beautiful.
Awesome. I love that.
Yes.
Yeah. We just lost our mics here, so we will we'll go to break. Thanks to the Oak Creek Lions Club. Have a great Labor Day festival.
Thanks, Steve.
I'm sorry, the board broke. I don't know what's going on.
We're stuck on. We're stuck on here.
All right, so let's...
More of WTMJ Now after this.
WTMJ's Jeff Wagner.
If it walks like a duck and it talks like a duck, it is probably a duck, right?
I have been talking about this for the last 4 years. I told you so, I told you so, I told you so. It's Jeff Wagner story time. If you want to take back your city, it starts by going to the ballot box and voting out the people who are letting this stuff happen on a daily basis.
Weekdays from noon to 3 on WTMJ.
It's time for the 2023 MBA Parade of Homes, presented by Nuns. See 12 new homes by 10 MBA builders in two locations, Renwood North, Germantown, and Redford Hills in Sussex. See the latest new home designs, grand finishes, and cutting-edge features in convenient subdivision locations that offer exciting opportunities to build your dream home. Don't miss the Metropolitan Builders Association Parade of Homes, August 12th through September 4th. For tickets and hours, visit mbaparadeofhomes.com today.
If you're a motorist of the four-wheel variety, please watch out for those of us in Wisconsin who do their traveling on two wheels. Adjust your mirrors to reduce your blind spots. Allow motorcyclists a full lane width. Use your turn signal when merging or changing lanes. And allow more following distance between you and the motorcycle. Motorists and motorcyclists can work together to achieve zero preventable deaths on Wisconsin roads. Zero in Wisconsin. Together we can save lives. Learn more at zeroinwisconsin.gov.
Sponsored by Wisconsin DOT.
At Kendor Marine, we have everything you need but the water. For over 50 years, boat